Live from the Toad Hop Network studios
in Hollywood,
this
is the ToadHopNetwork.com.
A place of our own without a lot of parents staring down our backs.
Radio worth watching.
And here we go.
Hello, Schmoville. That's right. It is the Schmoes Know podcast. And what a different setup there is today. A lot of talent actually around me today, which is surprising. I kid. Mark Ellis is out. He is performing. Tiffany is also on the road. But have no fear, kids. I am here with the co-host of the year, the producer of the show, Ken Knapsack. How are you, bud?
Good. A little rattled. We're okay, though.
You're
I got the
rattled?
Pocket square tonight. We're good to go.
You got the suit on. I'm
checking all the producer emails.
You're good.
We're here, though.
All right, good.
Welcome, Bonnie.
Thank
now,
you.
See, okay, no, you welcome.
Oh, you just blew my intro.
You just blew the intro. Now, last week, we did one of the most successful versions of the Celebrity Impression dating game. And our Bachelorette was one Bonnie Somerville, and now the co-host for tonight, taking
Yay.
The place of not Tiffany Somerville, Mark Ellis. Ken is taking Tiffany's
yeah,
place.
I'm
a girl's got a dream.
That was a worked contest, if you ask me.
It is not. It was not a
no,
work.
No, it wasn't.
Come on.
She
no,
had
wasn't.
No idea it was me.
No.
I just don't believe that one,
it's not
one
true.
Second.
Even though he says I have talent, mm-hmm. he shouldn't be saying that.
There's some kind of spiritual primal connection that we weren't aware
but
of.
But I am excited. This is a dream come true.
To co-host a show? Yeah. It's going to be a lot of fun. What are you babbling about there?
I last week, you know...
There's don't,
obviously
don't start,
some
don't,
sort of buried...
No,
hit.
Don't start rumors.
I'm not starting
don't
rumors. I'm just acknowledging
rumors.
What's already out there, by
There's
the
nothing
way.
Out there.
Dennis Miller was on point last
Dennis
week
Miller,
and should have been picked.
Dennis Miller was
Maybe
real,
I'm just sour.
You are sour. But look, Dennis Miller was really good.
Dennis Miller was really good. There might have been too many...
Yeah. But now, the reason we bring
Maybe
up...
Maybe you should only do three...
We're bringing up the Celebrity Impression Dating Game because if you go to our YouTube channel
so
right now, that episode is up there and we're going to give away a free Ripped Apparel shirt tonight at the end of the show. Bonnie's going to pick one of your comments, so go there right now.
Yes.
Drop a comment on the episode and let us know what you thought, anything that you want to say about the show, and then Bonnie will choose one of your comments and free Ripped Apparel shirt.
Yes.
Big show tonight, guys. A lot of cool stuff going on. We are very excited to have William Bibiani here from Crave Online, who's going to be talking movie news with us in just a second. And then in the second half an hour, we're going to have Christian Pitre from the new film Bounty Killer, which is going to be fun. Wildman
wow.
TV comes back, which I'm very excited about. Hear about all his fall TV picks, stuff that he wants to see, stuff he thinks is going to get canceled, stuff I really want to hear about. And then we're going to talk about some of the upcoming movie releases, stuff that's coming out this week that we want to talk about and chat about. But without any further ado, I'd like to bring in our first guest. Ken, why don't you give him the proper introduction?
Well, I absolutely will. He is the film editor at Crave Online. He's also the host of the B-Movies podcast, which is available on iTunes.
Yep.
And a very good show. We're happy to have him here. We ran into him down at Comic-Con, as you run into the entire universe. But we said, hey, we got to get your face on this show. So please welcome William Bibiani
yeah.
to the show.
Nice. Woo! I like the crowd. As he puts on the cans and
he just sort of
puts on the cans. What do you mean put on the cans?
Put on the cans. Not shove the cans
on
the camera. Yeah, they can see that. They can
see that.
Schmoville
can see
it. Hello, everybody.
Hi. Adjust that chair. We'll adjust that chair.
You're in Somerville right now.
Uh-oh. In Somerville. Who's been there before? Okay.
I'm going to hold on a second. I'm going to use Summers as a hand puppet here.
Yeah.
Higher.
There you go. There you go.
Good morning. Good morning.
He's using you as a puppet, Bonnie.
It's late to stay up late. Good morning. You're supposed to move your mouth.
Morning.
No. I don't think she gets it. He's using you as a puppet in the camera.
Oh, shit.
Never
mind. Wow.
There we go. All right. Here we go.
Story of my life.
William, welcome to Schmoville.
Thank you very much.
Very happy to have you.
Good to be here, Schmoville.
I was happy to bring you on, especially for this half an hour, because we're going to talk about all the new movie news that's happening this week. Love to get your opinion on it. We have talked many times. At the press screenings, about you're a very opinionated guy, very intelligent, know your stuff.
I have three opinions. I have three. Yeah, good, bad, and.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Well, I wonder how many of those we're going to get tonight. And also, just to let everybody know out there, around the 8:15, 8:20 area, Al Mayombe from Latino Review will be calling in with a new Star Wars
Latino
scoop.
Review.
Yeah, so we're excited
it's
about
Star
that
Wars?
As well.
It's Star Wars scoop?
It's a Star Wars scoop.
I'm excited.
Yeah, so, okay. All right, here we go. Now, Johnny, you ready for it? Johnny Ice.
Johnny Ice.
Man on a mission.
By the way, Bonnie, if Josh McCuga off puts you behind you, just let the proper authorities know. We'll take care of it.
That's okay. I play a detective on television.
There we go.
Hey, I'm Ken Abzug, and these are your Schmoes Know headlines brought to you by Magic Hat Brewing Company. Joss Whedon is the Jesus Christ of Marvel. At least that's the idea you get after the story that ran this week in which Thor, the Dark World director Alan Taylor, claimed that during the production of the movie, Whedon was called upon to help during the filming of some scenes that just weren't working. They prayed for help, and Whedon answered, flying into London just to rewrite a major scene. He flew in, rewrote the scene, and as he was getting back on his plane, Taylor claims he asked Whedon for help on two more scenes, adding that he reached out and touched his cloth, pleading, Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani, which translates from Hebrew into, my God, why have you forsaken Natalie Portman? Thor, the Dark World, hits theaters November 8th. Joss Whedon is available for baptisms. Perhaps Keanu Reeves can use the healing power of Whedon. Reeves told MTV that the, dare we say, much-anticipated Bill & Ted 3 is being held up because there is a, quote, darkness out there that is keeping it from happening. He also rambled, there's a lot of subterfuge and conspiracy theories, and it's pretty dark out there. But before you make fun of Reeves, do note that this may be what the Book of Revelation spoke of when it was written, and then the great beast emerged from the lake of fire to ensure that there would be no distribution deal. In a related story, Keanu's Bill and Ted co-star Alex Winter was unavailable for comment as he hadn't finished his shift at the plant yet. Kelsey Grammer.
He's a very hardworking guy.
Kelsey Grammer is set to join the ever-growing cast of The Expendables 3. Deadline's reporting that Grammer will play an ex-mercenary named Bonaparte that helps the Expendables on their mission. With the exception of the departing Bruce Willis, the cast of The Expendables now includes any male actor over the age of 50 who is free that weekend. Just text Stallone. Let him know you're in. The removal of director Bob Peterson from the movie The Good Dinosaur has delayed the release of that film from May 2014 to November 2015. This also pushes back Finding Dory to 2016, thus ensuring that there will be no new Pixar film in 2014, meaning children everywhere will have to get their entertainment from going outside and drinking rusty water from a sun-dried garden hose like a 1920s ragamuffin. To compensate, Disney has moved up the release of the Angelina Jolie-led Maleficent to May 2014. A spokesman for Disney said, we realize it's a long wait for a new Pixar movie, but in the meantime, we ask you, does a bear piss in a river? Find out this April in Disney Nature's Bears. Now that I have over 1,000 Twitter followers, Zac Efron is just barely the most famous alumni from my high school in Arroyo Grande, California. But at least I don't cause $50,000 worth of cocaine-fueled damage in Vegas hotel rooms. TMZ revealed this week that Efron has completed two rehab stints this year for cocaine and ecstasy-related issues, and that he struggled with the problem this year while filming Seth Rogen's movie Neighbors. Though, to be fair, there's only so much weed you can smoke before snorting a line while screaming, I'm going to be a Jedi, bitches, over the blaring sounds of High School Musical's two soundtrack. No official comment from Camp Efron, but if I'm being honest, I'd rather hear of a celebrity addressing and confronting their drug problems as opposed to stumbling out of the Chateau Marmont with a bloody nose and smelling like Charlie Sheen whiskey and semen. Earlier this week, Latino Review reported that James Cameron and Arnold Schwarzenegger would be reuniting for Avatar 2, set for release in 2016. The website cited top-level sources, which at this point may just be the devil himself, as 20th Century Fox, the studio behind the live-action Fern Gully adaption, was quick to deny the story. A rep said there is, quote, no truth to this. If it does happen, Arnold would allegedly play one of the film's villains, described as a fierce military general who refuses to acknowledge that one of the aliens is his illegitimate son, despite the kid looking just like him, but in a different shade of blue.
Oh, no, you didn't.
Finally. And finally, some television news. You may have noticed there were some cameras in the studio last week for the Schmoes Know Movie podcast. I can reveal here now that, as I suspected, the show, which Johnny Ice will play a promo picture of, is the Harloff and Somerville show. No release date announced.
Rumors.
You are an idiot. You know, Ellis is responsible for this.
You think so?
I think, yeah. You don't ever speak up about
this
type of
shit. Is that our Christmas card?
Yeah, for a little while ago.
You guys seem rather comfortable there.
You just stuttered.
Yeah, because it came out of nowhere because of you last week, and you do it, and you never open your mouth, but then Ellis cracks a couple jokes here and there,
Christian's
and then all of a sudden,
flustered now.
Okay.
I'm surrounded by these rumors, and Ellis is safe in Tempe in a hotel room.
So you're
going to
protect
idea.
Ellis. Okay,
drunk on Chili's
this?
Two beer.
God,
I know you don't like my habits. I know, I get it.
What? I didn't hear the ending.
What's that?
to stop the music.
Oh. I'm Ken Dabsuck, and those were your Schmoes Know headlines brought to you by Magic Hat Brewing Company.
Yeah, see? That's what he gets.
I'm doing triple duty today,
Johnny. You know
why
that is, Johnny? Because he's not a professional. That's exactly why.
Oh, really?
He decides he wants to play little jokes, and then that's what happens.
So we're not going to address it? Okay.
All right. Now, William, you are here now. Now, I want our guests to not be ignored from immaturity. Now, we have a couple stories out there. Let's start with the Arnold story, because there seems to be mixed reactions here. I would love to get your opinion on this first.
What aspect of it? Do I think it's a good idea, or do I think it's real? I mean...
Let's start with real. Do you think it's real?
I don't care.
You don't care? Okay.
No, well, here's the thing. Like, I think what everyone wants is like, oh, James Cameron and Arnold Schwarzenegger are going to re-team again, and maybe Avatar 2 won't suck. And it will, just like the last one. But, you know...
What?
Avatar...
That was an Oscar-nominated movie.
Yeah, because Oscars have never nominated or rewarded a bad movie.
Really? Seriously.
I'm sorry, I hate Avatar.
Don't you think it's like shtick now to make fun of Avatar? Do you think, like, everyone, it's one of the most profitable movies of all time, and now everyone hates it because it's a Fern Gully ripoff?
Well, that's
I like the movie.
James Cameron.
No, I don't think. Here's the thing with Avatar, and I've been saying this for years. Avatar is the most profitable, biggest movie ever. Oh my God! How often do you quote it in casual conversation?
Well,
how often do you hear it quoted in casual conversation? How often do you see it referenced in popular culture?
Yeah.
Titanic. Burst through that.
By the way,
immediately,
William. I see you.
And go fuck yourself. Okay,
that's the first time
since it came out.
That
all right.
Said it?
Like this movie. It's so generic and bland and full of bestiality and plot holes that I don't think it's nothing but shoving this guy's red rocket up animals to dominate them.
Alienality, buddy.
First time you see that fucker. First time you see it, they say, "Don't play with that. You'll go blind." What the hell else was I supposed to think it was? Arnold Schwarzenegger. Okay, so we're gonna get another. You know, let's assume for a moment that the story is real. I don't have any sources on this. I don't know. Let's assume for a minute the story is real. So the big story here is that James Cameron is basically bringing back the same exact type of bad guy from the first Avatar, only now it's probably Sully's dad.
See, I would much rather him be an actual Avatar. If he was the Na'vi, whatever. I would rather him be one of those.
Well, then there's freedom. Then we don't have to look at his weird face.
That's the thing. I think that's where I fall on this. Yeah. I think that if I'm with you, I think that if he's a human, I'm gonna be way more skeptical. If he's an alien, then it's cool, because the range is open. He can you don't care
about his stupid face and acting. And
he's just phoning it in.
Oh, he's back. Come on.
Bad. He is back. But I'm like, The Last Stand, I thought was kind of fun.
I thought it was fun as well.
But I mean. Christian's right. You can't take him seriously as a human because he is who he is.
Yeah,
exactly.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
There's no suspense of disbelief.
That's
but
true.
If he's a Na'vi, then that accent of his is going to not fit.
There
in
are other parts
world.
Of the planet.
Why not? Well, sure.
Well, maybe
but
don't they speak?
He's
yeah,
from the Austrian part.
I get that, but don't they speak in their own dialect and their own language? And he would have to whatever.
Right. You just got away with it. Why can't he?
Yeah, that's true. Well, there you go. I think it's going to be it's a very heated subject for sure. Regardless, it's going to have people talking. We'll find out, like you said, William, whether or not it's true or not. When we find that out, who knows? Now, the other thing that we were talking about here is this whole Thor and Joss Whedon thing. Now, Joss Whedon. it kind of makes sense, though, that he's going to help out in the movie.
It doesn't even make sense.
He's been hanging on forever.
He helped out on Captain America.
It is in his job description.
Right. Yeah.
That's what this is.
He has
the big
help.
Headline
so sense.
Is Joss Whedon did his job.
Right.
Like, oh my God,
I
Joss
have to help out
did
my,
his job.
I have to help out my second part of my movie
here. Yeah, exactly.
Here.
Yeah. That's like bringing in a ringer to finish a role that I already did. It's just weird, I think.
I don't even think it's weird, because the thing is, they put him in charge of like the creative direction of all these Marvel movies so they can lead up to the Avengers 2. That's the reason why he did some work on Captain America.
Exactly.
That's the reason why he actually shot that final scene at the end of the original Thor, the after the credits bit, so that they can keep everything tied together. So that is his job, is to go over every script, rewrite the script, make sure it works.
It all ties in. Yeah.
Exactly. So basically what you're saying is Joss Whedon came into work.
Did his job, right.
You know? Like, this is not news.
This is
what we wanted him to do.
I 100% agree with you there. When everyone's passing this article around, like, he came in to save it. No, he came in to help continuity.
And if you listen to the quote, what Alan Taylor said, he loved working with Whedon. It opened it up. It was collaboration. Yeah. It wasn't like he was taking over.
Right. So I mean, that's the thing. I think that was it's a silly story. Another silly story that I actually enjoy is this whole Bill and Ted thing.
That never ends. Is that happening?
I hope it is. I mean, but what's Dark Forces? I think is something where he's probably saying, Whoa, Dark Forces. Like, just saying something normal.
I think he was making a joke. No, he was probably using euphemism. Like, I don't know, guys. Feels like Dark Forces are out to get us. Right. I don't know. Maybe it'll come out. And then Dark Forces becomes the headline because that's the way you make a headline out of that.
Right.
Yes. And that sounds stupid.
I totally agree.
And, like, you know what? It's hard to get a movie made, even a sequel to a franchise. He's probably just alluding to that. If there is, however, a really vast Hollywood conspiracy to get Bill and Ted 3, to keep it from ever happening, what's in it for them? Yeah, who cares?
Whose life is so pathetic, they're like, I'm going to stop Bill and Ted 3.
I know, really.
Like, I feel like it's a Mike Myers character from like an Austin Powers movie. His whole like mission in life is just to stop Bill and Ted 3.
Maybe that's what the movie is about.
God, if you're going to stop sequels, that's not the first one I'd go for.
Which one would you go for?
I said, if you're going to... Where should I start?
Give me one.
Well, it's already a Doctor Who ripoff.
No, just all the ripoffs. Yeah. I mean, just all the repeat. I mean, it's just like original. I'm sorry. I'm all about original content.
I get it.
Right
now. I totally
agree with you.
I think a lot of people are. But the thing is, too, if sequels are done well, we eat them up.
Do we need any more Fast and Furious?
Yes, we need more Fast and Furious, and we need more Step Up. Be fair.
Have you seen 5 and 6? Be fair.
No, I'd rather shoot myself in the eyeballs.
The same way. This is a different conversation, but I felt the same way.
I'd rather
going
shoot
into
myself
it.
In my uterus.
Listen, the Fast and Furious movies and the Step Up movies are saving Hollywood from irony right
Who
now.
Who cares?
You're talking about money.
You're only talking about money. You're not talking about content.
I'm talking about movies that I enjoy watching over and over and over again.
I'm with you. I'm with Bibiani here.
Yes, because I have taste.
Yeah,
I
baby.
Oh, Deb's fighting words. Deb's fighting words. Oh, hell no. Oh, hell no. I know you did not just roll up in here and say I don't got taste.
I would appreciate you not making fun of my girlfriend.
I think you're a wonderful human being.
Thank you.
Who needs to see the Fast and Furious?
I just can't.
We had one more
I'll
story
see if
in
Paul
there.
Walker takes off his clothes.
Oh, the Zac Efron. Now, do we think he was method acting? Because he was in this movie where he had to go all shitty.
He was mething his face off.
He was mething. Maybe he figured, well, I'm on a... Or did he want to try to look cool in front of Seth Rogen and the gang and get a little screwed up?
He's playing a frat boy. Why would he be doing...
He's all coked up doing ecstasy.
I can't believe that he kept that. I mean, how did he keep that on the DL?
Well, he didn't.
He's in the news right now.
No, for a long time. I mean, every day.
He was a control freak.
It's pretty crazy that he was able to hide it for that long.
Because I know
true.
People that I've worked with that is it is
Matthew Perry.
I didn't say anybody.
Oh, I said it. Okay, so let's.
Wasn't that painkillers though?
I don't know.
I have worked with people that have a coke problem, and it's pretty obvious.
Yeah, I mean, the thing with Zac Efron, it's like these Disney kids, man. It's like in your contract, it's like by the time you're 20, you're going to be fucked up.
Right, like look at Miley Cyrus right now.
Yeah, I would rather not, but I absolutely agree with you.
Really? Aww. On that wrecking ball, naked? You're not
Ew.
A fan?
Ew. Oh, no. She's 20 years old. She's disgusting. Ew. Twerking.
If by disgusting you mean delightful,
no,
then
you
yes.
don't think that.
No, let me tell you something. What? Everyone's talking about Miley Cyrus. Everyone's talking about Miley Cyrus. Oh, I can't believe how sexual she was in the VMAs. Yeah, you know what? If she'd been good at it, we'd all been saying, oh, she's great. You know why? She had some talent at it. She actually showed me something.
That wasn't sexual at all.
That's the problem. Exactly.
It was the most unsexy thing.
It looks like what a 13-year-old thinks sexy dancing is.
And the tongue? Yeah. I'm sorry. That is... come on.
It's gross. And it's a shtick. And it's another thing. One of these things. Like, again, Madonna... as dirty as she was.
Don't compare her to Madonna.
You actually believed she had sex.
You believe,
Britney back in the day.
Dude, that was so hot. But I don't want to talk about this animal anymore. I want to talk about. We're gonna El Mayombe from Latina Review.
You have to yell.
I'd love to talk about Britney some more.
I know you do. You creep on wheels. We're going to have El Mayombe call in really soon, and we're going to have there's more. There's a lot of Star Wars talk already. Again, they're going to be shooting in New Mexico. They're going to what's her name? The girl that was rumored. Who was rumored today?
Bonnie Somerville.
Shoshana.
Well,
we've started.
Was it Saoirse Ronan?
Yes, it was. We have started rumors on this podcast before, Bonnie. So, have you had any contact with Marvel or Disney?
No, but I've had contact with Aliens.
Oh, okay. So your representatives good. Have not talked to you. Okay. So
me and R2-D2 are tight.
And is New Mexico confirmed? Because I thought that was another.
Is New Mexico
like,
the Tunisia of America now? Is that what's going on?
Yeah. I don't know. It's cheap. Yeah, I'm very curious where it's all going to go with this, too, because William and I were talking about this before the show started. And it's your point about this news, about Star Wars news.
Which I don't know what it is yet.
So. Okay, in general. Is the fact that it's, wow, they're making a movie.
That's really what most news boils down to until the movie comes out. Wow, they're making a movie. Wow, so-and-so is working on a movie. And then we see the movie. Mm-hmm. And I get it. We're excited. We all want to see, like, another hopefully good Star Wars. Wouldn't that be nice?
Yes.
But there is a serious, I think, danger of commoditizing too much information about a movie until the movie itself, even in the eyes of the target demographic, even in the eyes of the audience that really wants to see it, becomes nothing but, you know, a game of Clue.
Yeah, I love that you just used the word commoditizing in a sentence. I'm totally turned on right now.
Nice.
You're welcome.
Now,
you're welcome.
Yeah,
who the hell uses that?
Look, I agree with you, but the thing, what I think though, wait, oh, never mind. We have somebody calling in right now.
Yeah. Shit, because they just heard me say I'm turned on right now.
Calling in now, another New Yorker, our scoop, fantastic man himself from Latino Review. Welcome, El Meimbe.
What's poppin', cool kids?
All right, dude. So we're having a pretty conversation here with William Bibiani about Star Wars and Star Wars news. There's a lot of Star Wars news of it. Everyone's reporting on it here and there. Someone might be cast. They might be shooting here. I know that there's constant information about Episode 7. I know that you have something that you want to talk about. I would love to hear that news, and then we can respond on such.
Yeah, in my next scoop, I write a paragraph addressing the look. I totally get it. A lot of people are frustrated with, like, who's such and such meaningful, who are they playing, who are they reading for, what's going on, you know, and I understand the frustration, but we're not the bad guys here, you know. It's the studio who's taking this position of, we're not going to say or show anything because we know you're going to go see the movie anyway, so just deal with it, which is, I could be wrong, you know, not the position I think that should be taken. So
I think there's a heavier appetite for Star Wars too, because it was just some other movie that nobody cared about. No one would be reporting it, but because everyone's so interested, and we haven't had a good Star Wars movie since 1983, so we're very excited to hear about it. It's true, and we have a guy who feels the same way that we all do in this room, that we can possibly get a good Star Wars movie. So yes, I am one of these people chomping at the bits. Like we've said in the past shows, I've heard about, I'm not reading it anymore, but of course I'm going to read it, and that's why I want to shut up and hear what you have to say, my friend. What do you got for us?
I know. Never heard you do that ever.
Stop it.
Man, you guys are funny. So a lot of those, you know, normally for any other podcast, we wouldn't do a quote unquote taking a meeting story, as a lot of my colleagues put it. But this was exceptional. So there's been young ladies, young men that gone in to see, but there haven't really been any diversity. So David Aiello from The Butler and Red Tails went in for some unknown role, but here's the kicker. You know who else went in and met with JJ personally?
Who? Michael Jordan.
Fruitvale Station's Michael B. Jordan.
Wow.
I love that.
I love that.
The next
too.
Rumored friend, Johnny Storm. So Michael B. Jordan, but he's
going
on
in
fire
for Star Wars.
Right now, and he personally met with JJ.
Okay, Now do we think he's going to actually play a Jedi, or are they going to say, no, you're Lando's son?
Steve Calrissian.
Right, right.
I didn't want to say a Calrissian. Oh, why does he have to be a Calrissian? Why can't it be another character? You know.
Okay. Well, there's only like
sensitive types out there.
There's only like two black guys in like the whole.
Why
you
gotta be all
franchise.
Prejudiced, son?
I know it's true, but
exactly.
The tragedy.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Why? Because I've been following George Lucas since I was small. I mean, Mufasa Dupasa.
That's true. The darkest person is Chewbacca. Right?
Yeah. Well, Lando Calrissian.
Half of Darth Maul.
Okay, so how do we now again, I think that this goes back into what William was saying, though, too. It's fun to hope that Michael B. Jordan is going to be in this movie, but we don't know if it's going to happen. Like you said, Amiambi, it very well could tomorrow they say, well, it was a good meeting, but we're going to go with Zac Efron. He looks better as a Sith on Coke. So, you know, it's one of those things that just may work out better. What's wrong, Ken? You don't believe
him? He's out completely from what I heard.
It would make sense.
Didn't work. Boom. Gone.
I have a question. Is there any reason to suspect these guys are reading for the same role, or might these be different roles?
I think they're doing it in the way a lot of these superhero movies are doing it these days. They're looking for a specific type. Actors don't know what they're going in to reach for. They might research from a different movie that's in a similar vein or a different side in a similar vein. And they look for a type, and once they know what the type is, then, you know, they and they like what they see, then they give them a little bit more, and then they perhaps pick them the offer. But it's even, dude, it's gotten to a point where some of the Hollywood trades are even asking, yo, what do you know about this on Star Wars or that? Could you help us out? And it's like there is just radio silence across the board.
That's crazy.
Not, not just us, all media outlets.
Well, let me, that's what you get when you hire J.J. Abrams to do the movie. That's right. Sometimes I think that's half of why they probably hired him, was he'll keep it quiet.
But why though, then Kathleen Kennedy, why did she, like, 2 months ago say, we're not going to be silent, we're going to be very open with the fans? And then is that part of the rumored back and forth is?
Oh, then they stonewalled us at D23. Yeah. They didn't even give us a title or nothing.
D23 was what we say in Spanish, un fracaso. You know, it was just a disaster. You don't hype people up, charge them whatever they pay on tickets to go hear a sentence or two.
Absolutely. Let me switch here to another, you know, a casting that I know you guys are pretty deep in here, and that's this whole Benedict Cumberbatch thing. The rumor was that you guys reported that he was in, and then they denied it. It wasn't going to happen.
Technically, we didn't report it first. It was another outlet, but everybody heard this, you know?
Okay.
Although the Scoop guys and Scoop gals, they heard it. I'm just hearing it. So then it came out, it was debunked. But hold up, again, it's not true. I mean, he's been through this with Khan, that there was even a story out there that he got tired of denying Khan. And ended up being caught. All I'm saying is, this guy lied to you before blatantly. Right. He's doing it again. Basically, it's like, okay, if you read today's Variety article about Wolverine, Hugh Jackman's doing junkets for the movies, yet he's getting asked about Wolverine.
Right, like, why do you want to lie? No, look, I get it, because, again, an actor, and Bonnie, you could probably attest to this as well, you don't want to screw up your relationships, because if they say don't say anything, you're not going to say
whatever they say.
And again, like, even using, when Katie was on a couple weeks ago, when we asked her about the Marvel thing.
We have to bring up Katie every 2 seconds.
Oh, all right, so.
Awkward.
Well, but I think there's a difference, though, with you talking about the Khan thing, which, look, Star Trek Into Darkness sucked. I think I'm comfortable saying that. But you know, the plot was predicated on not knowing he was Khan. They structured the entire plot around the most obvious twist imaginable. But you know, still, they kept it secret for a reason, not because for the hell of it.
It didn't work.
No, it didn't work. But they thought it did. Yeah. At the very least, when you're keeping something like that a secret, it's like keeping the ending of The Sixth Sense a secret. You know, like, granted, that's a good ending.
I don't think that has been done since. Do you, The Sixth Sense?
Not specifically, no.
Think of a movie that kept that revealed. That secret.
That kind of twist, right?
When has that happened since?
It's hard. I mean,
it's very, very hard.
People just blow it.
But exactly. So, like, why would you not try to hide it? Yeah. When you're looking at something like a character or anything like that is directly related to the structure of the story and the way that the audience is going to experience a story, why wouldn't you lie about it if someone's up in your face saying, hey, are you plot twist? No, I'm not plot twist.
Well, they tell you what to say.
All right. So then, I mean, how about this then? So what do we think, or what, out of all these things that have been reported on and rumored, what do you think that you've got the most intel on that you think is legit? If you were to pick one that you said, this is the one I absolutely believe is going to happen, and it can't be, oh, they're shooting in New Mexico.
That was easy. Benedict Cumberbatch, 3-picture deal, small part in 7, and so he could do other movies, big time role in 8 or 9. I'm willing to put $1,000, put my money where my mouth is, as a bet. Got it from 3 different dudes that have never been wrong with me in 10 years that I've been doing this.
Wow, and there you have it. Listen to that. So
it's smoke screen. It's all smoke screen.
Dropping bombs here. We have a possible Michael B. Jordan. We have a meeting. It's very possible. He's very hot right now. It would be very smart for them to cast him. And again, like you said, it adds a little diversity and a fantastic actor to the fray, so that would be great. Yeah. Benedict Cumberbatch, you guys will all win $1,000 if he doesn't get cast.
He's awesome.
And again, check him out at LatinoReview.com. Thank you, sir. It's always a pleasure having you on the show.
All right, bro. Take care,
Talk to you soon.
Take care, man.
All right, William.
Yes.
Say your piece.
Oh, wait, that's it for me?
No,
you're kicking me out? Okay.
No. Say your piece about this.
Oh, okay. Well, about Star Wars?
The Michael B. Jordan thing.
Michael B. Jordan. Okay, listen. The real story here, I mean, when you're casting any major part in a movie and you're working in development, you put together a list of people you want. you know, list people who might be available, who are age appropriate, who are physically appropriate, who you think can give you the part. So that they're having multiple meetings with, you know, what may be the same part, what may not. What it really tells us that the real news story here would be is that they're looking for diversity in a Star Wars movie.
Thank God.
They're looking to hire a decent, good, and young actor.
Yeah, and thank God they're into finding good actors and not necessarily all these famous people.
Yeah, Dan O'Yellow's really, really great. Michael B. Jordan's really, really great.
They're going for talent. They're going for
talent, for once.
Yeah.
William, so you have...
Abrams is always good about that.
You have a short film that you're working on, or a web series?
I'm doing a web series. We're doing a web series, a Crave Online and Shock Till You Drop, hosted by myself and Ryan Turek. It's called Kings of Horror. There's going to be one episode a day throughout the entire month of October.
Wow.
Where we're going to be reviewing every day a different horror film based on the works of Stephen King.
Oh, yeah.
Including like some ones that like no one even really talks about or even knows about.
My favorite. Maximum Overdrive. Cujo.
Cujo. I love Cujo.
My favorite.
We have a fight about Cujo.
No one talks about Cujo.
Salem's Lot.
We should return to Salem's Lot.
But no one talks about Cujo.
Shooting
that movie the way she did in that car for that many days with that kid.
I was in acting class
with her, but can you imagine shooting that movie the way they did in the car for 35 days or something?
Absolutely. And that movie came out amazing. It's a wonderful thriller. I can't wait to argue with Ryan Turek about in front of everybody.
I'll make
sure you check that out, guys. And are you on Twitter, my friend?
I am on Twitter at William Bibiani, B-I-B-B-I-A-N-I.
All right, well, you got to come back too. We'd love to have you back on the show.
I'd love to be back.
Fantastic.
I'd love to have you back on the show. Oh, wait,
you.
I'm just a substitute.
That's right.
You're never a substitute.
I wonder why. It keeps things so professional.
I'm a substitute.
We'll bring
you
back when Katie's on.
Now it's getting to Macuga and on the greatest show. So
guess what? Substitute teacher boys.
You know, you want to get personal, buddy? Wait until the 8:30 hour. We'll be back. Schmoes No Movies Podcast. Thank you, William, for joining us.
Thank you, guys. All of you are amazing.
Coming up next.
I wanted to play a little bit, Iceman. I can't remember what this is. Schmoville always plays.
What is it?
They always recommend the music, and they recommend really good music. I'm trying to figure out which one this one was. It's very creepy.
What do you think?
I'm going to get it once it really starts going. Johnny,
The Grudge.
No. You want to get it to... Get me to a point where I'm going to know this thing.
Sixth Sense.
No.
The Shining. The Shining.
Oh, what is it? What is it? Oh, it's Insidious. Okay, great. I didn't pick that. They pick that today? Insidious? Wow. All right. Schmoville kicking us. All right, guys. It's the Schmoes No Movies Podcast. We just had William Bibiani here from Crave Online. Bonnie Somerville, my very...
What?
Going into the past co-host. You are very feisty tonight.
I'm feisty.
And I got one for you, though, too, even though I promised I didn't. How about not biting? All right, so now we're going Now we're going to go to... I wanted to let you guys know about something cool going on that I haven't talked about. And last week, I want to talk about this. MMA fan, boxing fan.
What are you into, Kristian?
Not biting.
All right, stop. MMA fan, boxing fan. And I trained for a little bit with this guy, and he was letting me know he has a gym that he's now opening up. And I want you guys to be able to help out this guy because he's really starting a really cool thing. He owns Body Boxing Bootcamp. And it's a fundraising campaign going on right now at Indigo, IndieGogo.com, to raise money to open up a fitness gym so he can kick a lot of people's asses. This guy's awesome, though, too. He really knows his shit. And, like, I was training with him, and he snaps a jab so fast. He's an amazing, amazing trainer, and I really want to help him out. So I wanted to read this to you guys to let you guys know what to do. So go to that website. And one of the things that you should do, if you guys sign up, there are great perks. Once he expands more and opens up more gyms, there'll be perks in it for everybody. So every dollar counts. So even the smallest little donation will help. Just go to IndieGogo.com and type in Body Boxing Bootcamp in the search bar. You can also go to www.3bbbootcamp.com to check him out and the bootcamp and see what kind of ass kicking he does every week. So just go sign up, and if you want to join him on his page, again, go to bootcamp.com, and you'll check that out. So anyway, that is the fundraising campaign. A lot of fun here. I want to introduce a very special guest with us today, and what a great, great name she has. Kristian Pitre here. How are you?
Hi, from the, fine. Thanks for having me.
No problem. From the new movie, Bounty Killer. Mm-hmm. And that they can find that on demand right now, correct?
Yeah, it is.
Very cool. And I want to tell you guys out there, if you want to see a lot of ass-kicking, sexy ass-kicking, check out this movie. It's a lot of fun. And I wanted to talk to you about this because it's got like a Sin City almost vibe to it, to where it's, you know, the style. So how did you come about the role? How did you feel about going into it? And had you ever played a character like this before?
No, I had never played a character like this. I came across this role submitting myself for different projects, and as soon as I read the sides for this character, I knew that I wanted to play her. Didn't know if I could physically, but I wanted to, and so I auditioned and got cast for it and then started training. I'm totally into MMA, too. I was like, the boot camp sounds fun.
That's awesome. It's good for you, girl. Yeah.
I don't do it, though. I want to. I just watched it for years and years, and I've been trying to meet Uriah Faber for...
Oh, yeah, man. That guy's
I love it. My husband's met him.
Yeah, the California kid.
Yeah, the California kid. So, yeah, so we just started training and figured it out, and fortunately...
Did you have a trainer on set?
Not on set. I trained with a guy named Alfred Kendrick for about 4 months before the movie started, learning like capoeira style fighting and some mixed martial arts.
Okay.
And then on set, we had my stunt coordinator, Randy Archer, who, you know, was really good about making sure things looked badass. But the capoeira was hard. Even Randy was like, why would you pick the hardest martial arts to train with?
It's kind of crazy. And you have a guy. Your co-star's name was?
Matthew Marsden.
And he was in Rambo.
Yeah.
Which I remember him because I remember he's got like a Jim Caviezel thing about him. So I was watching him in that movie. And you don't expect really fantastic acting when you see Rambo. You expect, fire shot! Is what you expect. And this guy is good. He stuck out because he's the one that Rambo yells at because he's the sniper in the movie. He's another guy I think we should see more of because he has that kind of charisma. Was it a lot of fun working with him? How was it your first day working with him?
Definitely. Well, I met him before we started shooting, and immediately we just had so much in common.
Yeah.
And he happened to be a black belt in Taekwondo, so... Even though his character, I don't know if you've seen the movie, character never once does any sort of martial arts. He only uses weapons. He's the black belt. I only did martial arts.
And why was that? What was the reason behind that?
I guess they weren't expecting to cast a guy who happened to be a black belt. Drifter's just kind of a guy that uses guns. That's why he needs a gun caddy.
Right, he needs so many. He didn't use a lot in Rambo either. Right? They never utilize it. It's surprising.
But he's really, really great at it, and he helped train me a little bit before the movie started. You know, he saw a couple things that I was getting really frustrated with.
Yeah.
And kind of met outside of everything and let the kids play on the playground, and him and I went and tried to learn certain kicks and things like that.
Cool.
But he was super supportive and just such a great guy.
Did you guys get hurt at all? Anybody get hurt?
We got hurt every day.
Yeah.
What was your most gruesome injury?
Yeah.
Gruesome, probably at the end of shooting, and I don't really even know how it happened. I had an entire side of my right leg was just black and blue, and I ended up going to the river just 3 days after we wrapped, and everyone on the river is like, what did you do to yourself? Right. Oh, you look so beat up.
I busted my
eye open, you know, with a rifle. It was injuries every day, yeah.
Yeah, because I heard you worked with a good friend of ours.
Who?
Oh, this is Garrett Busey. I heard that I was actually the one who bit your leg when you were sleeping.
Busey, I knew it. That's a good impression too.
Yeah, it's amazing, right?
How did you work? With that maniac? I mean, did he ever come up to you?
Did he ask you about crocodiles and purple sunsets?
Yeah. I would like to smell the left side of your left toe.
How did you know he said that? That's crazy.
The left side of your left toe.
Oh my gosh.
That's such a turn. Right.
I want you to record that on my phone so it can be my alarm in the morning.
Make sure you check out Bounty Killer, or I will shoot a squirrel with a BB gun purple.
Oh my God. That's uncanny. That's amazing.
He loves the word purple.
Well, what was it work like? How? Tell me a crazy story about Busey. Yeah,
well, I mean, here's the deal. I didn't have to shoot with Busey. I mean, right. I didn't get
but
to
you
shoot
heard,
with Busey.
But you heard stuff.
I love how you just corrected yourself. I didn't have to shoot. I mean, I didn't
I
get to.
I retract my previous statement.
So tell me something. Because obviously you get to set and you're like, dude, we did a scene with Gary Busey yesterday and he was chewing on a lamp.
It was a little wild. We... his whole thing was he didn't want to shoot a scene unless he got to shoot a scene with Mary Death. But there was no scene with him in Mary Death, yeah. So we kept trying to toss around ideas, and I kept saying, like, well, just let him walk into the middle of the city, and I'll just shoot him. We'll just kill him immediately, and then he'll be in the scene with Mary Death.
He couldn't come up with one scene? You had to have kept trying, though, right?
Well, we kind of kept throwing around ideas, but our paths never cross in the story. I mean, you've seen it. Yeah, they just never cross. Yeah. So he did upset. Call me over and sit me down at one point when I was trying to run and change clothes. He's like, Mary Death, I want you to say it. Mary Death, come over here.
Mary Death, come over here, please. Do you like lamb chops and green crayons?
Exactly.
He is the best.
Thank you.
I listened to both of the stories of how he died. I listened to his experiences on the other side. Yeah.
You
and
did?
I heard all of his acronyms that he does.
I met St. Peter and he was a pussy.
I met St. Peter and he was a Jew.
Yeah, exactly.
I made Matthew come sit down. I saw him walking by at one point and I was like, he cannot miss out on this. So I made him come sit down and listen for a little while.
It's incredible, right? So I'm just fascinated that you got to work with him. I was again watching and I was like, because I didn't know he was in it until I saw it, and I was like, yes!
It's a surprise!
Oh, so good. So, obviously, that was pretty crazy working with that guy. Now, the movie in general, is it based off a graphic novel?
Actually, the graphic novel was being drawn at the same time that we were shooting the movie.
Okay.
All by Henry, who never slept. A lot of Red Bull, I believe. But
maybe he's hanging out with Zac Efron.
Sure.
Yeah.
Maybe.
Yeah. I want to hang out with Zac Efron. Not for that.
Yeah.
It came out around like September after we had finished shooting in July.
Okay.
And it's all put out at the same time. It's based on the same thing. It's drawn in our likeness. And it's really fun.
Yeah. Ken, I know that you were, before we were talking about, just seeing more and more of the female action hero, which is coming out a lot. I know that you had something along those lines that you wanted to ask.
Yeah, do you feel like you were, upholding some kind of ideal for young women everywhere to be in a stripper turned assassin bounty killer? Did you enjoy that, finding a role like that that you could kind of sink your teeth into, as opposed to being screaming girlfriend in the back?
Hell yes.
Yeah.
Yes, it was I would think every female actress or female actress, every actress would want to play a role.
Every
like
actress
this.
Yeah. with a vagina.
Exactly.
Yeah. Yeah.
Those.
Yes.
I would think they would all want to play this type of a role.
Totally.
I mean,
I would kill to pick
she's just strong and sexy.
Chopping a head off with a boot? Did
oh
you
my
have
gosh,
fun doing that?
Yes.
Yeah,
and I actually got
training?
To help syringe the blood out of
awesome.
The neck that was chopped
and there was
off of.
A lot of practical effects in this, correct? I mean,
yes.
Not a lot. This isn't
yes.
a CG-based kind of movie. Did you get to do your own stunt?
Almost all of them, mm-hmm. yes. Mainly because we couldn't
bruise?
Afford stunt people.
Right.
No, cool. I wanted to, though. I begged them to let me do pretty much everything. And like you were talking about the practical effects, we had a guy, Chris Kabzina, mm-hmm. who was a finalist on Face Off this year. That just comes up with the craziest stuff, you know, and he's really a genius at what he does.
I love watching that stuff. I mean, CGI is great. I love the we're in the technology-based future, but just seeing, like, a model head blow up is kind of cool.
I kept saying it's shake and bake, and I helped because I kept getting to help over and over.
That's really
You're
cool.
You're awesome.
So I have a question. So Halloween's coming up.
Yeah, it's my birthday.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Is that your birthday?
Yeah.
So
that's a cool birthday.
Will you be going as Mary Death for Halloween?
I don't know. I've been throwing it around. My daughter really wants me to be the mother of Princess Merida from Brave.
How old's your daughter?
She's just turned 8.
Oh, wow.
What?
Okay, cool.
This past week.
What
I know.
Did you have her when you were like...
Yes.
10?
Thank you. I love you. I'm going to hug you when this is over.
You can hug me, girl.
And I will watch.
But I'm thinking about it. It'd be
and
easy.
And pick tomatoes.
You know?
Yeah. Purple tomatoes.
Yeah.
Actually, I was thinking about going as Nuri instead of Mary Death, so it's a little bit different.
Yeah.
I'm tired. All the outfits are covered in blood. I think Nuri's is clean, though.
Yeah. Well, that would be a lot of fun, though, too. And then there was something else I wanted to ask you, too. Oh, yeah. So did they use Bounty paper towels on set was something I wanted to ask.
Is that a serious question?
Yeah.
Submitted by Josh McCuga.
Just submitted by the wild man, Josh McCuga. That was you. I promised I would definitely ask that.
I would have to ask someone about that. I really don't remember any paper towels being on set. We were pretty dirty
mess.
All the time.
Yeah. They used regular towels.
Bounty, we would have loved for you guys to be there with us.
You also smoke a
lot
of cigars.
We had a lot of PBR on set.
He has a lot of cigars.
A lot of cigars. But you in the movie, are you now an aficionado? Do you now go down to the smoky bars, smoke with Jeff Goldblum?
Not really, no. And Henry kept trying to give me like a man-sized cigar because he really likes it when she like fights like a man, smokes like a man.
There's a difference in
there is,
cigar
but it just
sizes?
It just
anyone?
Looks well because he's giving me cigarillos. I ended up smoking cigarillos, you know, instead of actual cigars because it looked a little inappropriate.
Yeah, I think appropriate's all right.
You, I heard an interesting fact that you grew up obsessed with soap operas.
Obsessed.
This is what Ken Napsa does. He loves to throw rumors around
and present them
as fact.
Okay, well, I don't know about obsessed. I did grow up watching them with my mom when she was folding laundry and things like that.
Fair enough.
And not really them. One, I watch Days of Our Lives.
Well, that's worse than I watch Guiding Light every day at 2 o'clock.
I watch all my children because my grandmother did literally every day.
Yeah. See,
obsessed.
And that's what I told the person in the interview. I was like, you really just watch with whatever you grew up with, whoever was watching
soap operas
around you.
Whatever your family
watched,
you watch.
What do you got,
Cooks? Well, my mom used to tape Young and the Restless and Bold and the Beautiful. And then when I'd come home from school, we would watch them together as she ironed. You said your mom folded clothes. Yeah. My mom would iron and be like, I can't believe Victor. I'm like, he's an asshole.
crying. It's like other kids are crying about E.T. and you're crying about that.
Yeah. You're like, Victor.
Do you have any other post-apocalyptic movies that you love or any movies along that line that you kind of...
Oh, I can't stand movies.
No, you don't like movies at all? Were there ones in particular that you kind of drew
like, what,
inspiration
wait,
from?
What room am I in? I was supposed to be in studio number three.
We're just talking about soap operas.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah, I thought we were talking about Days of Our Lives.
Yeah.
Post-apocalyptic. No, I mean, I recently started watching Walking Dead, you know, with the zombies and stuff.
Yeah.
AMC, they just got the best show.
That's all I want to be on. AMC.
We just had RJ Mitty.
I know, me too,
week.
Me too. In fact, I hear they're looking for, like, they're going to have a new show when Breaking Bad goes away.
Well, because this low winter sun thing's not going to hang around that long, I'll tell you that. But yeah, we'll talk about that later as well.
I want to stay.
Stay.
Okay. Yeah. Well,
I want you to stay.
You need to sing on this show.
Rihanna.
You know, you need to sing on this show. Bonnie's a great singer, by the way.
That's true. I'm a really good person.
Yeah, well, let's not start more rumors.
Let us judge
that. Can we get Bonnie some more beer?
Yeah, please. Beer and sake.
This is good beer.
Yeah. We should have
sake. Good beer. Imperial beer.
Can we get a sake sponsor?
Magic Hat. Just kidding. That's what I meant. I'm in the past. Johnny Ice, this is why I don't do the reads.
Magic Hat. Wait, Christian, wasn't Magic Hat your old nickname?
It was, but you gave it to me. All right, so...
Oh, wait, you're circumcised. I forgot. I don't know that. That was just a total rumor. I made that up.
My wife listens
to the show. I just made that up.
Now you're being an
asshole. I just made that up.
All right.
Please, I'm godmother to your daughter.
Yes, I know. It's like,
what is going on? Yeah, you are, like I said.
Magic Hat would be a great nickname.
Anyway,
clarifying the Christians.
Yes. It was. This Christian is not circumcised.
I'm not
Christian
circumcised.
That was a total joke, okay?
Yeah, right.
Come on, guys. I was kidding.
All right. Anyway.
Lonnie's up past her bedtime. We apologize to the Schmoville
she has
audience.
Yeah, now Johnny Ice is trying to frantically find that picture again and flash the show. It's been canceled.
Did you watch a lot of like Mad Max or anything to get in the mood for this? How did you prepare to jump into this post-apocalyptic? Did you go to Burning Man or something? What did you like?
I hung out with Henry Sane.
Burning Man.
That's really all it takes. Just hang out with those guys, and you're immersed in, you know, all of it.
I'm fascinated by the fact that he directed a movie and wrote the graphic novel at the same time.
Yeah, that to me is pretty.
You don't
impressive.
Understand. You should have him on the show actually because
he's just exhausted.
He's a genius. Yeah. Well, yes.
Yeah.
He usually is. I think the past month I've seen him awake and alive for the first time ever. Since I met him.
It wasn't actually
ago.
Gary Busey. It was him. He was just so.
It was. Oh, that makes perfect sense.
Yeah. Well, so what's next with the movie and what's next with you?
With the movie, it's still out on video on demand. It will be for sale on DVD and Blu-ray eventually.
Okay.
We're hoping that, you know, it just kind of gets its little cult following going and that people like it and enjoy it and maybe want to see more because I know I would like to do a sequel. I really just want to wear the outfit at the end of the movie.
I'm sure a lot of guys want to see you wear the outfit.
Yeah,
have you seen it?
I can tell you all, she's very, very beautiful.
Would you consider going to Comic-Con 2014 as Mary Death?
Oh, yeah. I've been wanting to go the past 3 years as Mary Death, and they kept telling me that that's not what you do. You don't go dressed up as yourself.
Well, you could be the
Cranston
change.
Did this year.
Yeah,
that was awesome.
He dressed. Yeah.
He can do anything he wants
to. It's true.
Yeah, but so could you.
Yeah.
Why not?
You don't wear the band to the the band T-shirt to the concert that you go to, and you don't dress as your character at Comic-Con.
But what if your character is awesome?
Well, tell that to Walter White.
Well, he went around with the mask on as a joke.
But he walked around as Walter White.
All right. Yeah. All right. It's always conflicting answers here.
Yeah.
I am the one who knocks.
I don't want to do anything juvenile.
Purple.
Yeah. All right, so where, and I'm sorry, where did you, you may have asked, if I apologize if we're repeating this, but where,
what
did
are you
guys,
doing
where did you guys shoot? Well, I want to know where you shot first.
Oh, we shot, no, we couldn't afford to go that far.
They shot at Burning Man.
Yeah, it was in the conference room.
We shot all around. We were at the Blue Cloud Ranch in Santa Clarita, and then out at the El Mirage Lake Bed, you know, any piece of little desert, half of it was done in a backyard on a small piece of sand.
Cool. It was.
I'm halfway joking there, but only half. He looks at me completely seriously.
I don't know.
Christian was like, "Uh huh."
I don't know. I'm still thinking about
nothing.
Stupid things that have been said on the show.
Mary Death. Mary Death.
Mary Death. Now, Mary Death. Christian, what are you working on next? What do you have in the pipeline? What are we?
You know, I've been given a couple of scripts for these very similar type roles. But I was speaking to someone recently that was saying it might be fun to do a complete 180. So I'm kind of going to take a second and step back and maybe think about venturing off and then coming back.
Like,
I don't know.
Like a romantic comedy, or do you want to be the one being killed in the movie?
I don't know. Like maybe like a drama or just something. I don't know. I don't know what the 180
would you like
will
to
be.
Do a soap opera?
No. Yeah. Okay.
No.
I don't think so. I don't think you can go from Mary Death to Days of Our Lives.
That's true. You shouldn't.
What would you guess?
I'll go to Mary Death or Days of Our Lives as Mary Death and see if
You've really offended Josh McCougar
I'm
with
so
that
sorry.
Statement. He's very. You just broke
what
his
mean?
Heart. He broke his heart.
Poor Joshy.
Now, if you could have an idea, let's say you did the switch, and you have to pick one. You can't say, I don't know. If there was a movie that you wanted to do and a genre you wanted to do that wasn't chopping people's heads off with your boot, what would it be?
Drama.
Yeah. Okay, cool. Any particular director that you like that you'd want to work with? I know that right now we're pretty high on, let's say, David Fincher is a guy right now.
Yeah, we have... I say anyone that wants to pay me at this point.
That's what I say every day on Sunset Boulevard.
Yeah, exactly.
And it's also, but that's the thing, though. I think to the next switch that you do, it's going to be challenging regardless. And in a way, because you just did a really fun, kind of cool action movie, that a drama would be a change. Do you think you might find yourself being
bored?
Yeah.
Yeah, man. I just keep thinking about like Wonder Woman's and like those type of roles.
Yeah.
That's what's stuck in my head. That's why even, you know, I was completely gonna just keep going in this genre or these types of roles. But someone kind of threw it out there, like maybe you should pull a 180.
You should totally challenge. Yeah.
Bonnie, you've been
can I do just one more fun thing and then go?
Well, that's what I want to ask Bonnie. Absolutely. So Bonnie, you've switched up tons of times from the romantic comedies and you know, just played a cop for 13 episodes. So what would you say is a, you know, did you like to switch to keep
yourself
fresh?
I did sitcoms for so long that I was like the sitcom girl.
Yeah.
And it's really good to switch it up. And then you appreciate things much more. And also it doesn't give you typecasting.
Yeah, that's
true. And it is, you know, it is challenging when people, like with me, a lot of people don't want to see me for action roles now. And it's always rewarding when I go in and they're like, oh, I didn't know she could do that.
Right.
Nice.
But I haven't gotten the roles that you've done, but I would love to.
Have you ever done stunts or anything?
I did a few stunts on the Golden Boy, the show. I got to do my own stunts and a lot of chasing and gun shooting and did all that. And I was like, that made me want to do an action movie so badly.
Yeah, so you know the adrenaline rush.
But then now when I was on that, I was like, God, I miss doing comedy. Like Christian, he's always like, I would want to see you on a comedy. You want what you don't have. That's just the way it is.
Right.
That's true.
So do it all, man.
I've heard you say that before. All right, guys. So now we are going. Yeah. Now I wanted to talk to.
What does Dennis Miller say?
What does Dennis Miller say?
That's all we're doing today.
What I would actually like, speaking of the celebrity dating game, and what we do here, Kristian, we have a show that Bonnie was in last week, and we do a celebrity impression dating game where we have everybody in this room picks out a celebrity, and they do a impression. Usually it's bad. Josh McCougar, John Lovitz is horrendous. Can you give us a little John Lovitz real quick?
Come on, Joshy.
Hey, Kristian, Ed. Cool, Jack. Welcome to the town.
Yeah, see how hard that's. Yeah, horrendous. So, what we would love for you to do, if you're up for it, we would love for you to come back, and if you would like to be the Bachelorette in one of these.
So fun.
Yeah, Bonnie
that'd
was
be
last week.
Awesome.
We'd love to have you back. Yeah. Okay, that'd great.
So you have to make everyone close their up from now on.
John Lovitz wants you back too, Jack.
Yeah. Come back to the subway, eat fresh. All right.
That was good.
Thank you. then please do that. The invitation is open. Anytime you'd like to come back, we'd love to have you.
Thank you.
And again, check out, guys, Bounty Killer. And can they find you on Twitter?
Yes, they can. I'm at Christian Pitre _.
Okay. So there you go, guys. Make sure you do that. And it was very nice having you.
You're laughing.
What are you laughing about?
Well, it's because he laughs at everything.
Why did you point your
Did you laugh at Petri dish or underscore?
She told me to set up a Twitter account. I set up like something really hard to find, and she's like, it needs to be closer to your name, but my name's taken. So she said, put an underscore in it, and I put it at the end, and she's like, that's retarded.
I would like you to put...
She's like, who does that? It should be Christian _ Petri.
Make sure it is unicorn _ lamp friend.
Thank you, guys.
And I want to make sure that George McCann and the rest of the crew are drinking, because they made sure that they're going to do a drinking game every time I do my Busey, so I want to get
them
hammered.
I'm out of beer.
Good. So Josh the intern is on it. Guys, Christian Pitre, very nice to have you. Thank you for joining us. Check it out. Check out Bounty Killer. And we will be right back after the break. It's Schmoes No Movies with everyone in the damn studio. Some interesting music by Schmoville this time.
Drive?
No, this isn't.
No,
Drive.
It's not Drive.
I think I know what this is. Wait.
Ernest Goes to Camp. I win.
Yeah, he is.
Medea's Christmas.
Gilbert Grape.
Did you pick this music? Is this the one I sent you? Oh, yeah. That makes a lot of sense. Especially, you know what? I want to let it.
Country for Old Men.
No, it's from Breaking Bad. It's Walter
old
White's
country
theme.
For Young Men.
But there's a reason.
No
that
Cities
we
for
Breaking
Young
Bad.
Dudes.
All right. There you go. It's the Breaking Bad. It's Walter White's theme. Absolutely. Wow. Ken Knapsack, before we get into what we're going to do today with the man to my left, who I will not introduce just quite yet, I want to hear what the hell you're going to tell me about where, if I wanted to watch Breaking Bad, what do I do?
Well, this next segment is going to be sponsored by Hulu Plus. That's right. Hulu Plus is the sponsor of this segment, brought to you by this as yet unintroduced man here.
Are you having a stroke?
What's going on with you?
I don't know.
Call an ambulance.
I can't produce.
If you're sick, go to a hospital.
Be on the air at the same time. I'm learning.
To do the reads, Isaac?
Yeah.
He was listening to Chris Isaac.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. Wicked
Christian, I think he needs an ambulance.
Yeah, seriously. Ken just had a stroke.
If you're sick, go to a hospital.
I'm like Serene Branson on Channel 9 outside the
ambulance. You're like that.
Baby, what the boo? Exactly.
Krista Berg, Lady in Red, just got to Kenny Knapsack.
All right, come on. All right,
this next segment is sponsored by Hulu Plus, and you've tried Hulu, now try Hulu Plus. Hulu Plus lets you watch thousands of hit shows, including Breaking Bad, anytime, anywhere. Stream it on your TV or on the go with your smartphone or tablet, and don't stand in line. Are you going to ride a train and just stare at your feet? No, you want something in your hand to watch, and you could be watching your favorite shows on Hulu Plus. It's a great way to binge watch your favorite shows. They have a ton of episodes from great comedies like SNL, Community, Modern Family, South Park, Family Guy, and thousands of other shows. It is only $7.99 a month. That's $7.99 for all the shows and movies you can watch, catch up on current shows, binge on old favorites, or catch a great movie. You can do it all on Hulu Plus. Right now, you can try Hulu Plus for a couple weeks free on the Schmo. Just go to HuluPlus.com/Schmo and tell them that by that way, you're telling them the Schmo sent you. Just click on the Hulu Plus banner and please make sure use HuluPlus.com/Schmo so you can get extended free trial that is 2 weeks, and this helps keeps the show's lights on.
Mech.
Hey, you got it out.
Wow.
There you go.
That was awesome.
Hulu Plus, your sponsor of Wildman TV.
Wow.
Thank you, Ken. Thank you so much.
Yeah, all right, listen.
Please go to Hulu Plus.
Now, what I like about that is we're talking about TV, and there's a reason we're talking about TV, not just to have Hulu TV, then our great sponsor. We have a very special segment on here that we love to talk about. One of our favorite people in the entire world of Schmoville, Johnny, what do you got? Okay. Look at the screen and you'll see what it is. Ladies and gentlemen, it is that segment that we love in Schmoville. Please give it up for Schmoville's wild man, Josh Schmoville.
Show us your tits.
There's a dance. There's a that dance.
I love his dance.
He loves that. Everyone loves that dance. Yeah, that's a dance. All right, here we
You're
go.
You're twerking, baby.
There we go.
Oh, I can twerk.
Oh, right. I bet you can.
Let's talk about the news.
Yes.
TV news. What do you got? What's TV world? What do you got?
Well, it's been nice. Schmoville's been awesome with Wildman TV. They really have. Every time I post something on Twitter or Facebook about, you know, suggestions, I get just bombarded with stuff, and it's been awesome. So thank you, Schmoville, for all that. A lot of Schmoville came at me today about Sleepy Hollow. That was the show that they wanted to talk about. One of my good friends, Aaron Byers, is one of the executive producers on the show. And he would kill me if I didn't say something very nice about it. Now, I didn't, from the promos, I honestly didn't want to watch it.
Okay.
It wasn't in my wheelhouse.
It seems silly.
It does.
It seems,
yeah, it
how,
seems
Rip
odd.
Van, from, how does Rip Van Winkle time travel?
Right.
How does he do that?
Well, it's.
How does he do that when he's asleep?
No, but that's what, is he asleep and then he wakes up?
Basically, he is like put into a trance by witches.
Okay.
And he wakes up. He kills the dude. He is put in a trance by witches after in like the Revolutionary War with George Washington. He wakes up in modern day Sleepy Hollow. Now, I was, based on the promos, it was sort of like, you know, come on down to Jimmy's Hack Shack where everything's half price. I'm like, I don't really need to go to Jimmy's Hack Shack. But Schmoville, especially Matt Brown, shout out to Matt Brown. This dude just berated me with like, you got to watch Sleepy Hollow. You got to watch Sleepy Hollow, bro. So I watched it today, and I will give it this. It was an very entertaining pilot, all right? Problem with it is that you could have gone another hour, and it would have been a movie. Like, they wrapped up the whole show in the pilot.
What are they going to do? Weird. Like, where does it go? How do you do six seasons of that show?
I don't know.
That's what most pilots are. We're going to get them this week.
Yeah. But most a lot of pilots aren't, though.
Most pilots that I've done, I've literally said, where's this going to go?
Right.
And then they hire a great team, and on a good day, you're surprised.
But here's the thing.
You're canceled.
But let's take Golden Boy, for example. Okay.
Yes. No.
Now, Golden Boy had a premise that is very interesting. Had the lead actor been good, no offense. Not you. You were great. You were great. The lead actor was terrible. I'm sorry.
You mean Magic Cat?
No offense. I thought Theo James was horrendous. I thought he was the worst thing on the show. I thought that's the reason he got canceled. That's my opinion on it. But I think that
some women can say bad things about
it. She doesn't have to say anything about it. What I'm saying, though, is had you had a good character, and that is a show that had potential. That you could see there was an ending,
but you knew that it had a future because it was told A in a flashback, and B, you're left on a cliffhanger, which is how do we get there? But most pilots I've done, I've said to my agents, I don't understand what some of the pilots I've done, especially dramas. But like, for example, I was talking to Kristian, like Mad Men, right?
Yeah,
right.
I remember reading the pilot for Mad Men. January Jones, literally in the pilot, had three lines.
Yeah,
me, like an idiot that I am, passed on the audition.
Well done, Bonnie Somerville.
Thank you.
Well done.
Thank you. And this is why I'm here today.
Right. Thanks.
It's like 99 girls at a club every time I go to.
But no,
they
but
pass
that's,
on the chance with the madman.
But that's the thing that happens. You read the pilot and 50-50 of the decision is this could be either the biggest break of your career and they could pick you in episode 3 to blow you up or not.
Well, I was reading, there was a really, really good article. There's latest GQ, Bryan Cranston's on the cover, and he talks about how he was lucky enough that his agent got him, because he had done X-Files, he was on X-Files, and Vince Gilligan was on X-Files, and he remembered Bryan Cranston, and he sent him the script before he sent it to anybody else.
Yeah.
And he told his agent, do not show this to anybody else, we are getting this thing, and he got it.
Yeah.
And it became, you know, I mean, it was that role, and you just don't know.
That's
don't
what I've
know.
Been hearing for 15 years. Every time I pass on an audition, I've heard my manager say, Bonnie, it's a pilot. It's a pilot, you don't know. And you really, it could be the biggest thing ever, and they could your part could get huge, or you could get canceled.
Yeah.
Is like this was the ratings thing of this was the boon already. It's like Sleepy Hollow got huge ratings.
It did.
And it's going to stick around. Fox is the kind of network.
It got
for a drama pilot right now on network, big ratings. Yeah.
A lot of people talking about it. So let's get buzz.
Yeah. I don't know where it's going. I don't know if I'm going to watch it further, but I enjoyed the pilot.
All right,
I thought it could have been a good movie.
What else we got?
Okay. We got two episodes left of Breaking Bad.
Yeah.
Ugh.
We got two episodes left.
Bonnie has not watched it.
I have not watched one.
We're not going to spoil it. What I will say is that after this episode, I went outside and like took a breather.
Yeah.
Like
is that what you did outside? I don't think that's the truth. What did you really do?
I had a bottle of Jack Daniels and I sat by the pool in my building and I just had a little bit of moment by myself.
Listen, the show was super emotional. We're not going to spoil anything, John. It was super emotional.
John's got his headphones off.
Yeah. No, I know. He's ready.
I'm not going to spoil a thing.
He's on like season four right now?
No, I only got two episodes. Oh, my
Yeah, I only got two episodes, so I'm caught up.
So. Okay. So yeah, we're not going to do anything.
I've got 5 years.
Johnny, everyone dies.
By the way, everyone's on meth.
Yeah, exactly.
Spoiler.
So the movie, the show was very emotional, and it was the highest ratings that they've ever had for this show.
Which, to me, listen, Breaking Bad now has become this transcendent thing, okay? It's become where you're talking to people, and you're like, have you seen it? No? Okay, then we shouldn't talk for until you have seen it. My poor sister-in-law, she's been very sick for the last week, and she has sat and watched Breaking Bad for 5 days and called me now that she's totally caught up and was like, how have you not pressured me more into this? Like, how have you not just force-fed me this show? Because, honestly, it takes that whole thing. Like, it's sort of, everybody's like, you should watch The Wire. Okay, yeah, you should watch The Wire.
Wire is a great show. Wire is a great show.
Why is it a great show?
Wire is a great show.
Oh, Wire is an amazing
show. That's just
because
he's from Queens and he can't talk.
It's shot in Baltimore.
No, wait, stop for a second.
The Wire. No, wait a minute.
You're from Brooklyn, ball bag.
Wire.
You forget. Where are you from?
I'm from Flatbush.
I got to take a stop for a second because I need my crew here for a second. I'm bringing it out here because, again,
I have video of this. You want to go there?
You have a video of
what? You want to go what? You want to go down?
Now, look.
Do you want to go down?
She's been on this show.
I will take you down.
Stop. She's been on this show.
I have video of this.
You're the one that gave her alcohol before the show started.
I know I did, but listen, this
show. It's not about the alcohol.
Stop for a second. Let me finish for one second.
Don't boss me. You can't boss me anymore.
You did it for years. There's a show.
I have video footage of this.
You don't have video footage of shit. Look, for 2 years we've had this girl on the show. Not once she ever, until you started doing your nonsense last week.
This is the first time you've ever asked me to be a co-host.
Yeah, but
and you didn't, by the way. It wasn't you.
No, it wasn't. Yeah, I know.
It was Josh.
Other text. How come I never co-host before? Because Shmova has been egging her on as well. So thanks for that, Shmova.
Available.
Yes. See, Shmoville, thank you for that. So, take
guys, Bonnie Somerville just winked at me.
Okay, you know what? Just move on.
What video?
Hey, Christian, Katie's available right now. Can
good.
Get her
bring
in
her in.
5 minutes.
Bring her in. Okay. They'll never be on the show together. All right, here we go.
Go ahead, Josh.
Go ahead. Josh, sorry. Josh looks like a kid in the middle of a spell.
Yeah.
I don't want
like when my parents accidentally got divorced on Halloween 1994.
Josh.
I was like, macaroni and cheese.
This entire segment has been brought to you by a stroke. The entire casting crew, including me, has had a stroke for the last 10 minutes.
Okay, Josh.
You bring in the wild man, shit goes off the rails.
Wild man, what
I apologize.
Else?
Go ahead, buddy.
Basically what I'm saying is that we have two episodes left, and there is just everybody has a conspiracy theory.
What about
everybody
Homeland? Are you excited?
Love Homeland. Can't wait.
Because I stayed up till 4 a.m.
Tell me your story.
Tell
them.
I did not watch Homeland for 2 years because it was between me and the girl that I will not mention her name to play Damian Lewis's wife, to play Jessica.
Oh, man.
And it was down to the two of us. And we were
Get out of here.
No, and we were at the offices together.
So we could have seen your boobs like every other episode for two seasons.
Well, you can see them now. I mean, listen.
Can we get Bonnie another beer?
A girl's got it.
Bonnie's boobs brought to you by Magic Hat.
Oh, yeah, Magic.
I got video.
Magic Hat. No. It was between me and her, and I was like, I walked out of the Showtime offices. I was like, I got this.
Yeah.
I got this, and it was one of the best auditions of my life, and my manager calls me, and I went to Palm Springs, and I booked an expense by myself.
You spent the money?
I spent the money. As a treat to myself, I went to the Viceroy. I got a spa treatment. I was like, I got this.
I went to the Holiday Inn and looked at you in the Viceroy. It was creepy.
My manager calls me and goes, you didn't get, and I couldn't believe it. I was like,
I thought it was a lock.
So I blocked it and by the way, she's great.
She's good.
And I'm finally caught up.
She's no Bonnie Somerville, but you know, she's
no
good.
Bonnie Somerville.
I can't wait for Homeland. I will say this. I've been lucky enough to get some screeners of pilots and things from friends. What I'm looking forward to most, what I really enjoyed, Brooklyn Nine-Nine was shockingly hilarious.
No, come on.
Like,
really?
Very,
see, that
very
makes
funny.
Me upset
with
my really?
Dude, Andy Samberg,
you watch it too? Yeah, Riley, it's funny.
I was like, Andy Samberg had kind of like burned a bridge with me of just being like, he's awkward. He wasn't that good near the end of SNL. He's awesome in this.
Really?
Chelsea Peretti, breakout, awesome in it.
Really? You know what? Then the promos are not good.
No, they're not. And this might actually be something to watch on Hulu, perhaps, yes? Can we get that on
Hulu? I'd watch it on Hulu Plus.
Yeah.
But no, I'm serious. Not even the
I don't think it's there.
Okay.
It's on Hulu Plus right now. It'll go to regular Hulu next week. They do like the week.
Okay,
delay.
Okay, gotcha.
Brooklyn Nine-Nine's fantastic.
I'm happy to hear that because I like
I saw the screener. I was telling JTI. I saw the screener for the Michael J. Fox show. I mean, I love anything Michael J. Fox does. It's decent television. It's not something fantastic. I will say this. There is a bunch of shit going on right now that isn't any good. Like it's yeah.
There's so many bad network TV shows right now.
We're honestly in like a depression of good television.
Otherwise, no. Not unless you're on cable.
Unless you're on cable. Network television.
I literally said to my agents, I will do anything to get on a cable show.
Yep.
But network, after being on Golden Boy and having so many disappointments with network TV, they do not give you a chance. They do not promote. They you can't do what you want.
If you don't have the ratings after the first episode, network, see you
But you can't. But they won't let the writers do what they want to do.
That's the thing. Network is limited. Again, studio versus, it's almost that studio versus independent feel.
And also, it's middle America. Like, you're not allowed. Yeah. It's the conservative right with, like, they do not want to see what these people in this room want to see.
That's right, because again, like, look, you look at something like Breaking Bad.
Sure.
It plays to a specific
people
audience.
In Wisconsin.
Some people are loving it.
I do not want to offend.
But I know where you're going.
I'm saying small town, right wing
majority.
You know what it is? People with Nielsen boxes do not watch the shows that we watch.
No. Yeah.
They watch How I Met Your Mother. They watch Two and a Half Men. They watch CSI.
And that's
CSI.
The hard part. It's the middle. Yeah, you're right.
I brought this up before and got beaten over the head by Schmoville because it's the Big
Bang.
I'm
sure they're going to.
It's the Big Bang
me.
Theory. I watched clips of that play on my radio, watching ESPN, listening to ESPN radio, and I cringe.
Yeah.
But majority of people, that's what they like.
But it's the majority of
Americans. Them nerds are talking about science. Funny.
I mean, put it to you this way. The Golden Boy, we got 10 million at the end, 10 million an episode. On any other network, 10 million. I mean,
season.
I mean, Mad Men gets what, two, you know, cable? We were canceled after 13 because CBS gets on average 22 to 15.
Right.
Yeah.
That's why they're the number one network. They're not the number one network because these guys with talent and taste are watching it. It's because majority of America, no offense, they're not watching that.
Yeah. When my mom says, "Did you see the latest NCIS?" No, I didn't watch NCIS.
By the way, come on. How much chance do we have?
Yeah.
Shit, I'm never going to get hired in this town again.
What I will say is that the cable shows have been awesome. Really looking for obviously Homeland, Boardwalk Empire, the first two episodes.
Game
I don't know where
Thrones.
That I don't know where that show is going. Where
Which
Boardwalk's
one?
Go, Boardwalk
War.
Empire.
Yeah,
I don't know
I
where it's going.
I have
watched every episode of Ray Donovan. I've watched every episode of Low Winter Sun so far.
How
Ray
good
Donovan
is Ray Donovan?
Is fantastic.
Yeah.
Okay, Ray Donovan is fantastic. John Voight has been awesome. Liev Schreiber has been awesome. The whole family dynamic reminds me of like my fucked up mom's side of the family in Pittsburgh. Everybody's a fighter and everybody's on drugs.
Yeah.
What I will say about Low Winter Sun.
Yeah, well, okay? I have my thoughts on it.
And we talked earlier a little bit about
this. I want to get my thoughts on it.
Okay, listen, you can only pepper people so much to be like, listen, you need to watch the first 20 minutes of this show to get the next glimpse of Breaking Bad.
Right.
What Low Winter Sun is what we talked about with Sleepy Hollow. You can't carry a show about one major crime for multiple seasons. And it makes, Detroit is scary as shit, portrayed in this show.
But that's the thing. This show, from what I see in Low Winter Sun, and Mark and I goofed about it in our last Breaking Bad review, is that it seems like that ex-girlfriend that was just really hot, but she's just... That's all she's got.
Yep.
It's like there's nothing else to it. There's no like. There's
Don't
no
talk about me like that. I'm right in the room.
You have flavor. You have flavor to you. There's no flavor to it. And just like, hey, look at my tits. You know, that's all because
I'm
it's like,
sitting right here.
Yeah, but listen, there's more to it to just that because Low Winter Sun. That's all they have. It's just like look at this trailer. Now you have to watch this. They should just show a fucking whole episode of Breaking Bad in the middle of an episode to get people to watch because no one's watching it and it feels desperate.
Well, here's the thing. When you would watch a really good episode like this,
you're gratuitous.
This past episode of Breaking Bad, the one where me and Jack Daniels had a moment, okay? We did. Because I love television. And after that,
I love you.
And you Flatbush girl, you.
This is me on a normal.
What I'm saying is when you watch a great episode of Breaking Bad, you walk away kind of like your next little tense. You watch this Low Winter Sun, and I just walk away thinking like I got to do laundry. Like I just feel dirty about what I'm watching. Detroit looks hideous. The city, there's nothing to the city.
But Detroit is hideous.
I know, but you're like you're basically destroying America, and
but
you have two
depressing.
British. You have two British actors acting in like the most depressed American city, and they're
trying to be dark.
It's dark to be dark.
Why is every British person taking our jobs?
Okay, in moments of The Wire, there was funny. In moments of Breaking Bad, yes. it's funny.
Yes.
In Low Winter Sun, there's just moments that are so dramatic, you want to go watch Requiem for a Dream to get a comedy like comedy relief.
And that's, okay? And that's the thing, is that people, they think that just because everybody likes dark, they have to go
no.
dark.
Right.
And
by
it's
the
like,
way,
no, be
you,
real.
Yeah. You can't, that's why every time I do a role where the girl is supposed to be a bitch, I always say, nobody wants to see a straight bitch. You right. have to have levels.
You gotta be real.
Or everyone's going to hate.
I've seen you be real and a bitch. It works.
I am a bitch.
Yeah.
Right, but I'm also funny.
Yeah, that's very true. And so we
take it easy, Somerville.
Yeah.
I'll be the judge of that.
All right, baby.
Now, yeah, I agree. Low Winter Sun is just one of those shows that
like, I don't,
like, there's no talent. Levels. There's has, no levels.
I mean, are you dudes, kidding me? It's got a great lot of cast.
It has dudes from Breaking Bad. It has dudes from Walking Dead. Yeah. It has Mark Strong, who is fantastic.
Dude, I've never,
yeah, but it's the writing.
It's just,
you can't make that show. You can't. There's no. What can you do with those lines?
But they're pushing, though. They're pushing it so hard because, look, it's Breaking Bad, and there's our next hit show. It's like, and you know what reminds me of? It's like Sam Worthington.
It's like a spinoff of Friends. You're like, it's not going to work.
That's true. But it's like
Joey.
You just
compared Low Winter Sun to Joey. That is hysterical.
No, it's like doing a
spin. It's like comparing Sopranos to Saved by the Bell. Yeah.
When they shoved every group. Remember Couples or whatever, that British show they tried to run after Friends? They were like ramming it down your throat. This is Friends. No.
It's too
that
much.
That was lightning in a bottle.
Yeah, and the thing is with you have these
and not because I was on it.
No, but they try so hard to it's like, hey, watch this. I think that they actually did a disservice to themselves by putting it out after Breaking Bad.
I don't disagree.
Because
same as, do you remember the show Rubicon on NBC? AMC?
It was
a one season show. It was one of the few AMC shows that failed. And I watch most of the people in this room know I watch a lot of stuff. And Rubicon, to me, I was like, listen, this thing has legs. Like that show at least had some legs. With Low Winter Sun, I'm like, okay, somebody's going to get caught, somebody's going to get messed up, and Detroit is still going to be a piece of crap.
Yeah.
I don't know where this show is going. Same as Sleepy Hollow. Like, I can see, obviously, like more explosions and more Ichabod Cranes.
Yeah, I agree, but where does it go?
Right. I don't know.
Wait, have you watched, sorry, can I just ask one thing? Yeah. Has anybody watched The White Queen?
The White Queen?
On Stars?
No, but I had a cocaine dealer back in New York that was really...
Yeah.
He was Zach Efron.
I want to take a call from Schmoville here, and we're talking TV. We're talking the Non-Filter by Bonnie Somerville. Hey, you're in Schmoville. Who do we got? Sweet.
Yeah, that's guys, it's Tyler Myers.
Hey, Tyler. What's up, man? Tyler, are you drunk from my Gary Busey?
It's so good.
I'm hammered, dude.
Good. Tyler, what do you got about tonight, this very unfiltered show on the Schmoes No Movie Show?
He's like, where
should
I
start?
Tyler's
new nickname is T-Rip.
Where should I start?
YouTube today.
I'm sure. Let's.
I want to go back to the whole comedy, the network television.
Yeah,
sure.
Because when Cooper says, the show from the 99, I saw the first episode. I thought it was hysterical. I love the pilot. I can't wait for more episodes. But I also saw the pilot episode for the new show, Dad, and I thought that was just like, torture.
Terrible.
That
yeah, I heard it was pretty cheesy.
Which one?
Dad.
And it's Seth MacFarlane.
It's insulting.
Yeah,
I don't want kids, and this show makes
me. Thank you, Tyler.
It's birth control.
Tyler, thanks for the call, man. Great hearing from you. I watched the pilot simply just because. And again, like, my brother, who is a dad, Christian's who is a dad, Ken, who has multiple kids that he's fathered at the Northridge Mall,
and he doesn't know he doesn't know where they are.
Yeah,
by choice.
Johnny Ice, who has a kid, let's play stereotypes until somebody gets hit in the face.
So basically, Seth MacFarlane should stick to cartoons.
Correct.
Okay. No, Seth MacFarlane is a genius. I don't know. This can't be just him.
Whoa, let's throw that word around with a little less caution.
Really?
A little more caution.
You don't think he's a genius?
Comedic genius?
One note joke. Yeah, no.
I don't disagree with Ken here. I think that he's funny. I think that when it comes to Family Guy and the pop culture reference is very funny. I thought Ted was funny, but it was in the same vein.
Yeah.
He does do what he does really well.
He does
well.
What he does very well.
Family Guy's one of the most amazing
come on.
Shows. That's not a bad thing, though. That's not a bad thing.
And it'll keep him healthy for a very long time. Yeah. And he can live off that for a long time. Yeah. It's not that Apatow type of thing to where Apatow can move around.
Really? I love Judd Apatow, and I would kill to be in one of those movies.
I think his movies are way too long.
But it is one note. Yeah. Come on.
But no, I don't know.
There was
one
moment in This Is 40 when I left the theater.
I'm with you.
It is By the way, I'm
40 minutes too long is what I call it.
No, no. It is, yeah.
I leaned into my now ex-girlfriend and I looked at her and I said, I hate you.
Yeah.
Me too. No,
this might explain.
My point is, though, Apatow Freaks and Geeks, Undeclared. Like
And Geeks is perfect.
But that's what I'm saying. So you move around and you can see that. And then he goes to 40-Year-Old Virgin. But it's not all one note.
Every move. Let's say,
the last, four have been very similar to what Bonnie's doing.
It's all the same joke and the hipsters and the pot.
Seth Green started with Family Guy. Jumped to Ted. Seth MacFarlane.
I worked with Seth Green in an Oscar-winning film called Without a Paddle.
Is he circumcised? Seth.
I was can we lock Bonnie up? The French film Without Paddle.
Well, Seth MacFarlane started with Family Guy.
Yeah.
Went to Ted. Pretty much same thing. I don't think Apatow was my point. Was that he went from Freaks and Geeks? He didn't declare Freaks and Geeks, 40-Year-Old Virgin, knocked up, just moved around a bit. And then I agree with you. The last movies haven't been that good, and I didn't give them great reviews. But I just mean they're very different and not in the same.
You make a great point. Yeah. You really do. And I geniuses, I think it gets thrown around a lot, and I don't disagree with Ken on this at all. But Dad's is brutal.
I just don't think that's fair to someone to say, hey, you know. Because then you always expect that. He does what he does well, other than American Dad. But, I'm not surprised to see.
I have a tweet that just came in, from Mono 0521. Do you guys watch The League? Yes, because we have two friends on the show.
Yeah. Great show.
Steve Renazzisi, who's been on this show and is coming back on this show. And John Lajoie has also been on the show. Very good show. And I'm glad that it really caught on the way it did.
It is. The great thing about The League, again, is it they're all standalone, perfect episodes it's so bro comedy that it makes sense to a very niche audience, and it just keeps getting bigger.
I have a question. Yeah. You guys, you know, why hasn't anyone mentioned Orange is the New?
Oh yeah, well, Josh did.
Yeah, Wild Man. That's all I hear in the acting audition world. I'm telling you, every audition I go on, I haven't seen it. It's driving me crazy. That's
Bonnie,
all.
I'll tell you what, you would have killed in that lead role.
Can I tell you something? I can't believe you just said that, because it's driving me crazy. I'm not kidding. I have heard that from every.
That you would have been in it.
Destroyed.
Are there roles still possible for her to get?
Christian, since Golden Boy, it's all I've heard. You would have killed. I'm like, what is? I haven't seen it.
Well, maybe. I mean, who knows?
Go watch it.
This girl is now blown up.
But we were talking about too. And there's another point moving in TV. Bonnie and I talked right beforehand, and we were talking about how it's changed for actresses too. Like actresses
over
30 can get roles. Well, look at E. Falco and
the best
Kira Sedgwick.
Roles for women now are 30 to 45. I mean, those are the roles I want to do.
Yeah, totally.
I don't want to play girlfriend in a sitcom.
Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. pilot, which I saw.
My friend Jesse Bochco just directed the last episode. He loved it.
I want to hear about
it. Here's the problem with
it. Can you hold on to Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. for a second? Because I want to get to that. I want to take one more call from Schmoville, and then I want to get into S.H.I.E.L.D. because that's a big story. All right. Hey, you're in Schmoville. Who do we got? Sweet tits.
You're married.
Where were you? Where was that voice 10 minutes ago? Hey, you're in Schmoville. Who do we got? Don't make fun of the Schmoville now. Hey, who's this?
Celtics hat boy Ralph from Boston reporting for duty.
Nice,
Bastion, I love Bastion.
What's going on, man? What do you got? Hopefully you're on my side here.
Dude, honestly, I am trash for me, Gary Busey.
Good.
Isn't it good? It's so good.
Dude, get to your store, buy Magic Hat, and drink it.
Yeah.
And have it be a purple
store. I don't have Magic Hat. I am currently drinking it. Drunk has been brought to you by Magic Hat Brewing Company.
I would appreciate that you drink one more drink of your Magic Hat right now, if I speak.
Let's all drink some Magic Hat.
Nice. So what do you got for us, drunks? I love this kid.
It's awesome.
Honestly, I can't wait to see Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. Okay. I want to see what Joss Whedon does with that. I actually also can't wait for the last season of How I Met Your Mother. Not in a disrespectful way and so many things.
Just meet the mother already, for Christ's sake.
Yeah. Okay. Well,
but for me, honestly, these last two episodes of Breaking Bad... like their length and everything, it makes me like just as stoked as I am for Series 3 of Sherlock. By the way, Harloff, you better watch Sherlock.
I will.
Next.
I promise, man. I promise you. We're going to get to it, man.
What about the White Queen?
Just to let everybody know, and the fact that you asked me to, I have watched the pilot. I want to watch the rest of it before we review it. Mark and I will review it. I promise.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Back at a revival and all that good stuff.
I love this kid. All right, dude.
I want you to yell more.
Dude, you sound like my buddy Jimmy Fisher.
You sound like my mother.
Bonnie just quoted me back in 2005. Okay, guys.
Have another drink.
I will talk to you in a little bit. Thanks, dude. All right, so
here's what happened. My buddy who worked on the show sent me the pilot. Those screeners that get passed around for Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. And obviously, all of Schmoville, we all love the Avengers. We all love this whole thing. My only problem, it's going to be good. Clark Gregg's an awesome dude, great actor. The whole thing works. The only problem I have is it's like, let's all just be models fighting crime. It's just like seven models from Central Casting fighting crime.
That's what they said, and they said everybody is there a chance for a crossover or no?
They'll see some crossovers, I think. I just don't... the superhero television show, it seems a little too bubblegummy, and I just think people are going to be a little oversaturated with it.
You know what? Yeah. My friend, I'm going to ask him to come on. He just directed last week an episode. Jesse Bochco, the guy that I worked with on NYPD Blue.
Is he Stephen Bochco's son?
Yes. And he's one of my dear...
Shocking that he does well in entertainment.
No,
I'm kidding. I bet he's good.
He actually has had to work really, really hard, and it's taken him a while because of being that. But
sure.
He told me it was the most amazing... I'm going to ask him to come on.
Okay.
He told me it was one of the best experiences, the most fun he ever had last week doing an episode of that show.
I'm sure... I love the pilot, and I think that the Avengers thing, it's obviously his giant market appeal. It's fantastic. It's just like, can you cast people that look normal?
See, I agree.
Like, why does everybody, if you're a superhero, why do you have to be a model?
Exactly.
Yeah, I mean.
Not everyone can be, like me, a superhero and a model.
Oh, yeah.
Like, cast a Josh McCuga in something, a dude that's
normal. By the way, thanks for spreading the, that I've had a lot to drink, because every tweet, Bonnie Somerville, good drunk relief. I'm not drunk, people.
She's not drunk.
I'm not drunk.
No, this is just her therapy
session. She just buzzed.
This is our therapy session.
Well, is Josh.
I know. I still want to get to before the segment's over and before the show is over. I want to get to this alleged tape apparently that Bonnie was talking about as well. We'll talk about it at the end. See how sober she was in that one. So
drunk. Look at all these tweets.
Okay. Drunk and be drunk or something. We'll talk about it in a second. McCooks, what do you got for us? Anything? Or is that our wrap up? I mean, that's
well,
a lot
you
of
always
stuff.
You always want me to tell you like you got to watch. You got to watch a show.
Yep.
I know everybody like talks about it, always gets nominated for things, and I was always like, this show's stupid. Dude, watch Downton Abbey. I was like,
it's good.
What? This show was like, all right, I'm into it. Okay, I'll get the pilot. And now I'm like, fuck. I'm watching everything.
It's like, you know what it is? I was too. I stayed up. By the way, Theo James, he played Palmook and he was great. He played the handsome Turk.
Well, he wasn't the lead.
He was great on that show. Anyway, it's like classy porn soap,
really?
But it's still a soap.
Yep. Oh no, it's without a doubt
it's
a soap.
It's like because it's British and it's, but it's
like
still
it,
soap.
People like
and
it.
I enjoyed it. I never thought I would like it, and I do. But I would say go out and watch Downton Abbey. See what all the fuss is about.
Guys, go watch The White Queen on Stars. I'm not kidding.
Leanne, the Schmoville Photoshop queen, writes, Bonnie is not drunk. This is just all natural exuberance, baby.
Thank you.
She's not.
Christian, come on.
Bonnie is not drunk at all. Bonnie is definitely.
You've seen me drunk.
I just knew that Bonnie was going to have some fun tonight.
Thank you guys. I mean, I love being Wild Man. Love Wild Man TV. I love you all. Thank you so much.
Wild Man is
I
the
love
best.
Josh.
Make sure that you
Josh.
Follow Josh McCuga at Josh McCuga. He is the Wild Man. He
and he's cute. Very cute.
Very nice. Very nice. Look at that. Maybe.
Am I blushing? What?
Do you ever see that episode? Do you ever see that episode of The League? Was it the Eskimo Brothers?
All right, guys.
So now we are going to move on to we're going to go into upcoming releases. There is a lot of stuff coming up that we are going to. Josh, the intern, is blushing over there. Look at him.
Come here, Josh. Sit on my lap. Come over here.
Josh, the intern. All right. Now, JTI, I'm actually going to have you stick your mug in. Come sit over here for a second. I don't know how much I want you to talk, but you can sit there for a second.
No, I'm just kidding. Look at his hot T-shirt. Right, hero.
I'm going to take a phone call here. Before we get into this, let's take one call. All right. Hey, you are in Schmoville. Who do we got?
Hey, Christian. What's up? It's Tony Morrow.
It is the Morrow Man. What do you got, Tony?
What should we talk about? What TV show? What, The Avengers? Or
You tell me, dude. You called in.
You called
What do you got?
Let's talk about Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. I have to say, in regards to the Avengers, I'm not the biggest fan of the movie. I enjoyed the film, but I'm not the biggest fan of it. I like Dark Knight Rises more and all. But speaking of the show, let's talk about this.
We talked about it for a little bit. You know, I think that McCook is right. It's fun, but the model thing, eventually you're like, okay, there's just a bunch of models running around kicking ass. How can you really invest in it? So I think he made his points there.
Yeah, it's true. Why can't they look real?
We'll see. You got anything else, Tony, or is that it? How are you feeling about the show tonight?
Very good. Cool. It's just awesome to have Bonnie on the show.
Thank you.
Yeah, Bonnie's always going to be back.
No one's ever said that. Thank you.
All right. Well, thank you so much.
Bonnie.
All right,
I
guys.
I love you.
Thank you, Tony. All right. Upcoming releases. JTI, we have some cool stuff coming out this weekend.
What's coming out?
We have the Prisoners, which Hugh Jackman, Jack Gyllenhaal.
Can't wait for that.
Oh, that looks amazing.
Ellis already saw it. Now, this is why I missed it.
I was wondering about that.
I missed it. It was Thursday. I'm pulling into the lot at Warner Brothers. Because, by the way, I've been getting a lot of shit from Schmoville about, hey, how come you have not been there for this review? A couple things happened with work. But this particular day.
And my goddaughter got a big boo-boo.
This is the thing. I was driving into Warner Brothers. I was pulling into the lot. As I pull into the lot, I get the phone call from my wife about my daughter's finger. Oh, I had to turn out of the lot and go, and it probably was a good idea because had I been in the theater watching this movie about an abducted daughter,
you would have missed.
Yeah,
and then
you would have been crazed.
Yeah,
and by the way, Vivian is my goddaughter, and she's gorgeous, and she had her little finger slammed in the
door.
That's
weird. Yeah. She's my goddaughter.
God. Look at this. See,
we got godfather and godmother here.
Yeah,
I like this.
This is a strange podcast. Uh-oh. All right,
but I want to say to Schmoville,
you
are so committed that you stayed in the hospital. And your wife is so awesome that you were like, I got to make the podcast. And you just, you know.
And I love what she said.
I don't know if that means you're really good at your job or you're really bad dad.
Kill it.
I love that. She's a good woman.
It was a Rocky II moment. So
and she's going to be okay, everybody.
Yeah, she's going to be okay. I mean, it was, but again, that's why I missed the screening. So I got a lot of shit for it. But Ellis saw it. He liked, again, you can check out the review. This is something I wanted to say to people who have not. If you just started listening to us found us from Toad Hop or found us on iTunes, please check out our YouTube channel. I know there are a lot of people who found us on the podcast first. Go to youtube.com/schmozno or schmozno.com to check out the reviews. Mark has his single review of The Prisoners, and he thought it was very dark, good movie, great performances, which I probably could have told you from the trailer for sure. But he said it's very disturbing. He doesn't know if he could send people who are parents into it because they'd be just really...
You know, I watched his review, and immediately what I thought of was Mystic River.
Me too.
Which is a fantastic movie. So I can't. And I saw when I was in Vegas working, and I saw that 10-minute spot of The Prisoners. They've had me ever since, and I want to go see it this weekend.
Yeah, I do want to see it. I think that I might wait for a little bit. Yeah. I do.
Wait till Viv is better.
I do want to. I mean, she's good. She's doing well. I want to see the movie because I also want to see. I'm at this point.
I'll go with you, man.
Yeah, but at point.
I'll go with you, man.
At this point,
Godfather and Godmother.
Just the fact that like they have these performances, and it's the end of September. This is when you start kicking in. JTI, how are you feeling about this movie? Do you want to see this movie? How are you feeling?
Yeah, I'm really interested to see Hugh Jackman tackle like a real serious role.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, he does all these big budget films. I want to see a movie where he's not singing every single line. And he was great in Les Mis.
Dude, there's a ton of emotion in that
know.
Movie.
And Wolverine, by the way.
He was the best part of that movie, Les Mis.
But hands down.
That's why I was excited to see him take a different role like that. And I'm excited for this because it's a regular speaking role. Right. I'm sorry, I'm just not a huge fan of musicals.
Dude, I'm sorry. Kate and Leopold was a dramatic turn.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah, which was amazing.
Dramatic turn almost into a
I heard his, by the way, I don't know if anybody in Schmovos has heard his Howard Stern interview where he talked about getting Wolverine. And I don't know if anybody knows that it was really, you know, he had to.
I know he talked about it at Comic-Con. He was not the first choice.
No, yeah. And he worked his butt off.
Wasn't it Doug Ray Scott that was originally going to do it? And then he dropped Doug Ray Scott. Exactly. But he dropped out to do Mission Impossible 2.
And he had to work his butt off. And it inspired me as somebody who's been around. Like he's been around.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Doug Ray Scott also lost the role of Aragorn last minute.
Doug Ray Scott.
Yeah. He was up for Aragorn and he lost it to Viggo. Viggo came in last second.
Doug Ray Scott just tweeted into the show.
No, we didn't.
Bonnie Somerville is an asshole.
No, Bonnie, this isn't at Night of Steel 87. Bonnie Somerville is just good relief. Good hot relief.
Oh, see? Yeah, baby. Thank you.
That's sex pot. All right. So, Yeah, so that is the movie that's coming up.
And Rush.
I think Rush does not come out this
week. It's limited release this weekend.
Yes, which I also saw.
What else is coming out?
Well, we can talk about it. If it's limited release, I mean, again, I'm going to tease this for every single review. That one is also out on our YouTube channel if you want to see. But Rush, to me, when I saw the trailer originally, I was like, uh-oh, we're going to get Days of Thunder here. No. I can say this. It is not Days of Thunder. And nothing wrong with Days of Thunder. But Days of Thunder is a different tone of movie. This movie is based on true events. And this guy, Daniel Bruhaha, what's his name?
You were telling me about this.
Bruhl, this guy could possibly get nominated. Yeah. This movie is something I will say that if you have a chance to see Rush in limited release, see it.
Yeah.
So that's limited release. And then the movie I know that JTI is very excited about, and that is Battle of the Bands.
Oh, God.
You ready to start
I don't
dancing?
Think I've even seen a trailer
Has anyone
for
seen 20 Feet from Stardom?
No.
Or what's that?
What's that?
That's
right after the Homeland Edition?
I don't...
Wait, what's Battle of the Bands?
Such an ape. No, it's like an indie. I heard it was really good about music. I forgot you don't like art films.
No,
Kristian,
I said to you,
you ape.
You didn't even get that joke. 20 feet from Stardom.
Are you talking about me?
Yes, right after your fucking audition.
Mine
right
is called 15
head.
Minutes of canceled shows.
Yeah. I can't win. I see. Josh,
no, sorry.
A lot
sorry.
Of people don't have those
Josh,
canceled
stay,
shows
stay
on the resume.
At least I've got 15 of them.
That's right.
Okay, so
wait, did you skipped the battle review? Didn't you?
I missed everything.
I understand you missing that one. Though.
No, I want. Look, I want. I like
sorry,
to see everything, especially
child.
Horror films. I like to see movies. Like, but the thing is, what really offends me because. My wife watches
Insidious
2 that last week came out.
Yeah, you saw that.
Yeah, it was all right. I like James Wan, but the movie.
You like Rose Byrne, don't you?
She's okay. I don't necessarily think it was any of the actors that I had a problem with the movie. It just got a little silly after a while.
Yeah, see, I wasn't a fan of the first one, so I don't want to see
really?
The second one. Yeah,
I didn't see it.
And then when he comes around and does The Conjuring, he blows me away.
Yeah,
so
well, that's a different, totally. You know. And The Conjuring, based off those true events and the way he shot it, and
yeah.
It just, everything worked. It was a good, chilling, creepy type of movie.
I want to do one of those movies so bad.
You did a horror film, though.
I did that movie
with Val Kilmer. And how did you wind up seeing it? How did you like
it? I
did. It didn't come out that great. Okay.
Nah.
That's what I like about Bonnie. Bonnie's very honest about her movies, too.
It sucks.
Quick question about Rush.
Yeah.
Would you say it's a back to form for Ron Howard? Like,
yes.
I mean, like 100%. Apollo 13
Old Ron
backdraft?
Howard? Because that was the best Ron Howard.
And we say this in an interview about Ron Howard. You feel his stamp on this film. You couldn't have told me who the hell directed The Dilemma. I would have never told you. I have no idea.
Oh, God,
that
I know.
Did
Ron Howard do Beautiful Mind?
Yes.
See, that's the Ron Howard that we love.
I want the splash Ron Howard.
Well, you're not going to get that. The Hans Zimmer score is great. But it's what it is that I'm not a racing fan.
Yeah,
I don't watch Formula One. I don't know shit about it. However, I found myself mesmerized by this
stuff. Is Chris Hemsworth really good?
He's really good. The thing is, he's not the – but the funny thing is, he's on all the billboards. He's not the star of this film. He's
really?
Great. He's not the star.
Who's the star, Herbie?
This guy's Daniel Bruhaha.
But the screen time is 50-50, would you say? So?
I would give Daniel Bruhl probably like a 65.
Oh, so he's 65 but
Chris is good.
Wow.
Chris is great. Look, Chris Hemsworth.
Because we saw Paranoia. So
that's his brother.
We shouldn't talk about his brother.
No, but Chris Hemsworth and Miley Cyrus. Chris Hemsworth is a movie star.
He's
a star, man. This guy reminds me of like young Brad Pitt. Like he's got that
Robert
charisma.
Redford.
Well, I don't know if I go there yet. As far as talent goes.
No, but I mean he's got that
presence,
something.
100%. He's got that thing. He shows up and you're just like.
You're like, I want to watch him.
This guy's got something. You want to watch him. But it's Daniel Bruhl playing Niki Lauda that it's the story. You're so going back to what you said before as far as interesting character.
Yeah.
Playing of a character, making someone human. That's what this guy
does. That's what to me, like every acting class I ever took that was meaningful was make the person real and relatable. And those are the people you fall in love with because that's us.
Well, this is like the first film Chris Hemsworth has really had a chance to like play a real character and act because, I mean, he does Thor, Cabin in the Woods.
Yeah.
And he was really good in the very beginning of Star Trek. But for me, I'm excited for Rush because this is an Oscar-caliber film for him to do something.
Yeah, I think if anything Oscar-nominated comes out of this film, it's going to be Daniel Bruhaha.
Gotcha.
All right.
Bruhaha.
Now...
You're talking about me getting drunk, and Josh keeps coming in with beer.
That's what he does.
Come on.
Now, the other thing I wanted to talk about was I want to get into this Battle of the Band thing because what pisses me off.
What is Battle of the Bands? I haven't even heard of this.
My wife watches So You Think You Can Dance.
So do I.
The show, listen,
she has
as much
taste.
As reality TV is horrendous, this show I understand why people like it, because there's true talent that is put on these shows. Is it something that people listening to this particular show or you or I are going to watch all the time? No. But there's talent involved, so I don't mind that it's on the air and they put on good music. But I mean, not a but. And what they do, I guess the producers of this show, they put in real dancing bands and stuff that they have a story that kind of goes. It's the classic kind of basketball. Oh, we got the little guy who the team that can't get along to finally put it all together. And they,
Rudy.
Yeah, but as a team that works.
Oh, that was football. Sorry.
But, Sean Astin, that I might say.
No, yeah. But at the event, but Sawyer from Lost, yeah, Josh Holloway is in it. And he's the coach. And,
oh, that movie. But that's Chris, not Battle of the Bands.
What's it called?
I don't know.
Battle of the Year.
Battle of the Year. Whatever. Oh, close enough. Do you want me to remember what the name of the movie? You really care?
Yeah, you're a host of a goddamn movie review.
Yeah, but it's called Schmoes. No.
You dumbass.
Exactly.
You know what? I cannot. Do you know what, Somerville? By the end of this show,
I will
it's on.
Punch you in
it's,
the uterus.
It's on now because I'm going to have a little surprise.
I'm going to talk to your wife later.
Yeah, I'm sure you already have. All right. So now,
Battle of the Year. Battle okay. Of the Year. So now, I kept racking my brain.
Chris Brown is in this fucking thing, too.
Oh,
how
Jesus.
Do you put Chris Brown as and not put him as a villain? You can't put this guy. Yeah, you can't put him in a movie to where he's going to play a redeemable character. There's nothing he can do that is going to make me like him at the end, unless Josh Holloway gets the smoke monster and fucking kills this motherfucker 10 minutes into the thing.
Unless Gary Busey comes in and says, "What, Christian? Go."
I would like to beat you over the head with a microphone made out of cheese.
Bravo!
Microphone made out of cheese. So, good one.
But anyway, it is absolutely something that I don't want to see because of that. And I hope, not because anyone else involved, I apologize, but it's the same reason people wanted to boycott Ender's Game or anything Mel Gibson is in. Sure. It's like, you want to boycott something, you boycott the movie that this motherfucker who beats women is doing. That's
I
the
totally
movie
agree.
You boycott. So,
yeah, don't even get me started.
Yeah,
don't
no,
even
listen,
get me
and,
started.
And again, speaking of which,
yes.
And I would like to talk to you about the
thank
reason
you.
Why this is.
It is so offensive to me, yes. And thank you for giving me the plug.
Yeah,
I said
no,
this
but
last week.
I'd like to.
I'm on the board of a charity called Face Forward. And it's an amazing charity that provides reconstructive surgery, aftercare, transportation, medicine for victims of domestic abuse, men, women, and children. And it's a very small LA-based charity. It's only 3 years old, so we need a lot of help. It's not celeb popular. And you can go to the website, www.faceforwardla.org. Okay. And it's personal to me, and this guy just fucking makes me sick. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
I mean, the
why'd
fact.
Why'd you point at me?
No, I didn't. Mean
Chris Brown.
I think
right.
She's
Chris
referencing
Brown.
But
the
your
fact
points.
That the fact that these people get chance. I mean, it's like I can't.
What
I can't.
What it is though, Bonnie, is the fact that people are supporting, and that's why I don't understand because. I don't understand who cast this guy, but let's move on from this shitbox.
Yeah,
but please go to the website.
Please do. Yes.
And honestly, guys, if you can't afford to buy a ticket to the event, literally $20,
$20,
$50. Yeah. If 200 of you donated $10 or $20, it could pay for a hotel stay for one of the patients that need surgery. And I would really appreciate it.
Yeah, and everybody, I've done it. It is absolutely a
please
worthy,
do.
Worthy
$10,
cause.
$10 and anything you can and. If you donate a lot more money, we can maybe Schmoes can come up with a, I don't know, kissing booth or something. Me and Katie, I don't know, or just me,
yeah. Sure,
or just me. I'll make out with somebody who donates $1,000.
Where was that suggestion 5 years ago?
How
all
about
right, guys,
this? You donate over $500, I'll make out with you. Go.
Wow. All right. Good. Now, how about this other movie that's coming out that is in limited release, another review that we did called Enough Said, and Bonnie wants to hear about this one
if
too.
If they donate $20, I'll make out with you. Josh says.
Oh, with who? With you?
With okay. Josh.
All right. Enough Said is a movie that Mark Ellis and I also saw with Julia Louis-Dreyfus.
I have another drink.
Is this Gandolfini?
And Gandolfini. And the late Gandolfini.
The late,
it is a romantic comedy. And this movie is a movie that it's a different kind of romantic comedy that I liked. I didn't love the way I wanted to and thought I would because in the first half an hour of this film, you see the back and forth between her and Gandolfini, and you get what everyone said about Gandolfini, was that he in real life, he was this lovable teddy bear, and you see this and the humor in him. You find it all, and it's this great chemistry these two have.
Sure.
And then they get into this thing. It's almost like a Three's Company deal to where it relies on the sitcom maybe because they feel they have her in it and they have to do that, and they really don't. But I still think it's a good movie for a date movie. Have you guys heard of this movie?
I heard, and I have a friend who works with Julia and does her hair for years, and he's on Veep, and he said that the movie is really like special. Like
I liked it. I definitely liked it.
Don't you think there might be a little bit of an emotional attachment because of Jimmy's?
Absolutely,
you know,
absolutely. And look, I was watching the movie and I was sad watching it because I'm like, this guy was such a tremendous talent and he was so good and he gets you on board with these things and like. And it's the way he delivers stuff, and you got that energy from him and that caring, like, lovable thing about him that it's just it's a talent gone way too soon. And he's going to be back again because he did a movie with Tom Hardy. I don't know if it's his
Animal Rescue.
Yeah, I don't know if it's the last one, but it's one of the last ones.
Now, yeah, that's what I was going to ask. This can't the Enough Said wasn't the last time.
No. It wasn't the last time. No. Okay. Okay, so before I want to talk about a couple other things, take some more phone calls from Schmoville, but before we do that, now, guys, you know that Ripped Apparel is our sponsor. I am wearing a great Goonie shirt. JTI is wearing.
And I don't have one yet.
No, what I'll get you. I'll get you one anytime you want one.
All my Ripped shirts are in the laundry right now.
Yeah, you look hot though. You're wearing a black button down.
Thank you. Hot. Wait, that was a quote. I'm writing that down.
Everyone except me got a good looking quote tonight. So we
been there, done that.
Oh, look, she's definitely on fire tonight. I'm not gonna take that away.
This is great.
Now, we Ripped Apparel, we have a code every month, and this month's code is SK Riddick, starring Katie Sackhoff. And if you check that out.
She's great.
Yeah,
I like her.
And you can get a dollar off her shirt, and they're such great shirts. If they're mixtures, I have a Goonie shirt on and the Drive shirt with a mixture of it's from an anime also, right?
Kira.
Okay. Kira. So it's absolutely go to Ripped Apparel, type in SK Riddick and get a dollar off. All right, let's take a couple calls from Schmoville here. We're at 323-622-8623. Anything you want to talk. If you want to ask Bonnie some questions at this point, go ahead and do it. I don't give a shit anymore. Here is, hey, you're in Schmoville. Who do we got?
Hey, it's Tony Morrow again.
Uh-oh, how did we get you again? Wait a minute.
Hang up on him.
Oh, wait, no, yes. All right, what do you got, dude?
Well, speaking of Ripped Apparel, I've been trying to get some shirts on there. I saw this really cool one of the aliens with Ripley and Hicks and Vasquez. I've been trying to get that shirt, but it's always out of stock.
It's never they only do one day deals.
One day deal.
If you don't act in those 24 hours, you're shit out of luck.
Yep.
That stinks.
Yeah, it does stink. I like my quote. Thank you, Tony.
That
all right.
Stinks.
Okay, next. That's a good call. All right, next call. Hey, you're in Schmoville. Who do we got? Hello. Hey, you're in Schmoville.
This is Daniel from Your Blenda.
Daniel, what's up, dude? What do you got?
Hey, I'm just wondering, I follow all this Oscar nominations and stuff.
Yeah.
But one thing that really pissed me off, I'm not going to lie, is why the hell do some of these, like, really good performances, like Benedict Cumberbatch in Star Trek Into Darkness,
mm-hmm.
Hugh Jackman in Prisoners, everybody says they have great performances, but all I'm seeing in these Oscar considerations is that they're dark horses. You know?
Well,
that's what people love.
Well, you know what it is, though, too, is because I think what happens is the studios know that you get your front runners and the performances, and when you see the releases that you're going to come out in like late October, November, December, when those movies hit, those are the ones that the studios really know they have something with performances and directors and actors. So they put it out there, and then you'll get people, again, like Michael B. Jordan from Fruitvale Station, mm-hmm. might be one of those guys that gets a nod or because the performance was just so special.
Right. I don't know about Benedict Cumberbatch for Star Trek Into Darkness.
Too big budget of a film.
I agree. It's just like,
it didn't hit in that way. But
another one like Meryl Streep she has the August Osage country movie coming out. Yeah. I mean, she's already a frontrunner. I mean,
well,
I'm
it's
sure
like just cast her, and she's in the Oscar consideration talk.
She's got more nominations than any
actress. I think that's
Hugh Jackman, though, I will say, broke through finally with his nomination for Les Mis, and so now Prisoners, depending on how well it does,
I think it's gonna have problems. I mean, not problems, but the fact it's gonna be hard because you're gonna have these performances that come out in the next couple of months, that the Oscar movies start coming in heavy, but it just depends. But that's usually why it depends on
when Prisoners comes out and what the reviews are like, and if Hugh Jackman is the one that's like, whoa, he stands out, then we'll talk.
All right, let's get some more calls here. Hey, you are in Schmoville. Who do we got? Oh, gone. All right, let's try it again.
Who's this?
Hey, you're in Schmoville. Who do we got?
Hey, 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 it's Joseph Hemmings from Australia here. How are we all going tonight?
What's up, Hemmings? What do you got, dude?
Energy.
Hey, I was just, if we're talking about upcoming release.
Where'd he go? Oh, Joseph, call back in. I'll take your call, dude. I don't know what happened there. Hey, you're in Schmoville. Who do we got?
This is Michael from Washington.
Hey, Michael, what's all up, right, man? What do you got, dude?
Oh, listen, first-time caller, sorry.
No sweat, man. What do you got? Thanks for calling in. Welcome to Schmoville. What do you got for us tonight?
Thank you. I just wanted to know your take on, like, I understand all the TV shows, but animated TV shows, are you guys into that or not into it?
Animated? Which one do you mean? Do you mean like comedies, like Family Guy, or more like anime? Like what type of animation?
I'll just make it simple. Young Justice, the one that recently got canceled.
Young Justice.
About a year ago.
I've never heard of that. I think that's a question that we have to maybe there's more stuff. Maybe studios need to promote it more. By the way, I am retweeting a picture right now from Leanne that I guess Leanne was spying.
Not from my video footage.
I guess Leanne was spying or something.
Is the worst picture. I look like an orangutan.
Bonnie, flip that. I want to see that.
But
what the hell is up with my eyebrows?
Go ahead and check out.
You know who I look like? Teresa Giudice from Real Housewives of New Jersey.
You know
my
that,
eyebrows
you know
are
that,
connected to my
Do you know where that
head.
Picture is from?
That's a nice chin there,
that picture
Christian.
Is from Nip Tuck, and you have been photoshopped over Katie Sackhoff.
Of course.
That's fantastic. Make sure, guys, if you're watching this show and listening to it, even if you're listening to it on iTunes, go back and retweet that picture as many times as you can.
No, don't.
Retweet it as many times as you can.
No,
please, all Schmovillians, please do that. And
Schmovillians. Listen, forget Schmoville and come into Somerville.
Been there, done
that. $20
You can
come
in the
summer.
Thank you for the
call.
Thank you for the call.
Things are getting very raunchy.
It has become a crazy, crazy thing.
Things that make you go.
Hey, you're in Schmoville. Who do we got? Sweet tit.
Hello.
Hey, you're in Schmoville. Who do we got?
Hey, I was just calling. I just wanted to say that Breaking Bad, you know, obviously Walter White. That's just one of the best performances ever. I mean, on a list, what would that rank?
Breaking Bad, I don't know if it's just because I'm so high on it. It is absolutely in my top two or three shows of all time. It is. Thank you for the call. The thing with this show, Riley, I know that we both kind of got on it at the same time here.
Yeah.
It is just so brilliant. It's like one long movie. There's even if you had a problem with the Fly episode, which some people do, some people don't.
Yeah.
It's still the show. It never sucks. It wasn't an episode.
You know what I mean?
Remember like Lost? Like there was that run where people were like, I hope it gets better. And then it was Breaking Bad, and it's just like epic. Nonstop epic. And I can't, like, it's my number one show of all time. I don't know if I'm just too into
we're high off the meth right now.
I wanted to settle down and sink in and think about it, you know, after it's over and go, okay. But right now, it's number one.
Yeah. All right. I'm going to take another call from Schmoville here, and then we are going to find out about this notorious video. Hey, you're in Schmoville. Who do we got?
Somerville. You're in Somerville.
Stop it.
Oh, hi. I'm Thomas Hughes from Winter Park, Florida, USA.
Nice, Tom. Right. Winter Park. Right, nice, USA. Man. You're not a Gator fan, are you?
Please don't.
I wanted to bring up the Doctor Who 50th anniversary special. I don't know if you guys watch the show or not, but
not you, that guy.
With this being pretty much the curtain call for Matt Smith, with him leaving the series this Christmas and David Tennant returning to the role, just pretty much a dream cast. And if you guys do watch the show, what do you guys think of it?
Thank you for the call. Now, Doctor Who is something that it's like one of those things that I keep saying to myself, I have to watch it. Me I love too. Time travel. I know that's the basis of the show. I've never
that's
seen
my that's my only dream in life.
It's a time travel?
That,
yeah.
That would be my superhero.
To travel in time. That's my dream. And just to watch or to actually be able to alter time?
No, just to
watch.
Just to go back because I'm a history major. Yeah,
where would you go if you had a time machine?
Anywhere, please. Egypt, medieval England. I mean, you name it. 1920s right. Hollywood.
So, I want to get into it. Schmoville. I was thinking about going into it.
Schmoville, 1910.
We got 2 minutes. What do you got?
Well, I was just talking about Doctor Who. I just wanted to get into it, because I have so many good friends who I trust their taste. They love it.
Everyone loves it. I mean, and you know, Matt Key, who's a big friend of the show, loves it.
Yeah, writes for the
his
site.
Girlfriend. All right, guys, this is an incredible show. A lot of fun. I'd like to thank William Bibiani for joining us. I'd like to thank both Christian Pitre and everybody.
She was great.
She was really fun. And she's going to come back for the celebrity dating contest, which is a lot of fun. Make sure you check out the Bonnie's charity. Make sure you check out
www.faceforwardla.org. Thanks.
Check out the Knapsack files. Check out www.schmoesno.com. Now, before we go, we have 2 minutes. You mentioned footage, video. What footage do you have?
I don't know. What do you want to barter for it?
No, do you really have? You don't. I mean, I know that you. But that's
wait,
silly.
Wait, what do
you
wait, got let's for talk
me?
The barter.
What have you done for me?
No, because the reason I say that is because Ellis said. All right, fine. To be continued later. All right, so guys, make sure you retweet the shit out of Leanne's poster.
Leanne, you're awesome.
She's so good, and that last one was really good. Guys, this was a fun show.
You guys are awesome.
Who we got next week? You know, off the top of your head? No, you don't. Great.
Can
great
I come
producer.
Back every week?
Yeah, you can. We'd love to have you back.
I'm working on some guests. So,
tons of guests.
I want my friend Jesse Bochco to come on, who just directed... Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. Well,
absolutely. We're going to. Guys, it was great to have Wild Man TV back. Great show.
Wild
Schmoes
Man TV.
No
I love
movies.
Him.
Love you guys. Follow us on Twitter, youtube.com/schmoesno. For the great Johnny Ice and the rest of the crew, peace out, mother effs.